Ladies and gentlemen, this bonded security agent has just placed a certified check for $25,000 in one of these 30 surprise packages. Tonight, someone may win any one of our fabulous prizes, or that grand prize of $25,000 on the new treasure hunt. From Hollywood, it's the new treasure hunt. And here's the host and star of our show, Jeff Edwards.
Thank you. What a nice group. Very nice. Thank you very much. Welcome to the new treasure hunt, the television program with more prizes and more cash than any other show in the world. Tonight, the combined total of cash awards and merchandise is over $200,000. We pre-selected 10 members of our audience to go on game one. We're about to narrow that 10 down to three, and one of those three is going to go on a treasure hunt. Okay, will the 10 people for game one please hold up your boxes, hold them right up. Now, if you have a number, three of those boxes contain cards with numbers 1, 2, and 3. If you have a number, we want you to stand up. Ready? Open your boxes. Good luck. If you have a number, stand right up. Here's one. Oh, there's two right behind you. There's three. Come on down here. Here we are over here just a little bit, and you come right down here. All righty. Now, as you know, there's a surprise in one of these mini treasure boxes. The one of you who gets that surprise is going to try to find television's richest treasure. So, who has number one? You have number one. Which box would you want? I'll bring it right to you.
I'll take
one. One right in front of you is yours. Who has number two? You do. Which one do you want?
That one.
She says that one. That one she gets right in there. And that means... You get that one. That's right, because you had number three. There's the three boxes, and we'll discover who goes on that treasure hunt for $25,000 right after this message.
Charles Nelson Reilly talks about game shows.
I love going to do game shows. You don't have to be too smart, a little clever.
The Eskimo said, if I don't have blank at least once a month, I go crazy.
Nanookie. Charles.
Well, actually, that's not the name for it in Eskimo. It's Canuck.
I've had a wonderful time, and these people became my friends for life.
What a show!
Get in on the fun. Watch Game Show Network. Why does everyone love the new Game Show Network?
The emotions, they're just so contagious.
I always love just watching people spaz out.
It's exciting. It's fun.
I sit in front of the TV. I scream out the answers.
That's right. You're wrong.
I'm addicted to game shows.
Needlepoint is marvelous therapy.
Everybody wants to win.
I love to win.
All right.
Game shows is where it's at.
Tune in to watch, play, and win on the all-new Game Show Network.
Let the games begin.
Welcome back to the new treasure hunt. Okay, now, whoever gets a surprise is going to go on a treasure hunt for $25,000. I'm going to open the little hooks here, and we're getting ready to open the boxes. Ready? Okay, you ready? You ready? Open your boxes. Here we go. Here it is. You're going on a treasure hunt for $25,000. You two ladies, please take your treasure boxes back to your seats. You're going to exchange them later for some nice gifts. Thank you for being with us on the new treasure hunt. Come on over here.
Oh, God.
What's your name?
Delia Cunha.
Your first name?
Delia.
Delia, how you doing?
Now, I'm scared now.
Well, I know you have some family here because your daughter's just screaming her head off up there. In just a few moments, Delia, you're going to walk up there, you're going to choose a package, and that package could represent anything from a jackpot and prizes to a real clump, Delia.
Yes.
Or it could be our grand prize of $25,000 in cash.
Okay.
Now, okay, sure, that's okay. Before you make your choice, we're going to show you some of the surprises hidden among those 30 packages. For example, Delia, you could win this.
How about spending your next vacation in this beautiful and sleek 17-foot tri-V hull ski boat pulled by a sturdy Vanson trailer from Warner Boat Sales? And with it comes this powerful 70-horsepower Triumph motor by Evinrude. This sensational ski boat, motor, and trailer, plus two special treasure hunt added surprises, bring the total value of this package to $7,832.51.
Okay, Delia. Now, not only that, do you like that boat?
Yes, I do.
Then you're going to like this, because one of those packages contains this.
It's a fabulous Clipper MK-26 sailboat, including working sails, dinette, sink, icebox, and pop top, allowing full standing headroom. All standard equipment from Clipper Marine Corporation. And to pull your boat, here's a custom-designed trailer. To this package, we're also adding $1,500 worth of merchandise of your choice from Spiegel, which brings the total value of this nautical showcase to $8,510.84.
You go up there, pick the right package, bring it down here, and make the right choice, and you'll win this.
It's a spectacular Aztec cruiser by IMP, with a 188-horsepower Mercruiser engine pulled by a sturdy Vanson trailer from the showrooms of Warner Boat Sales in Sunland, California. Plus, $500 worth of merchandise of your choice from the famous Beagle Catalog Company, featuring over 50,000 quality items, providing value, selection, and savings. Spiegel, Chicago 60609. Total retail value of this fabulous sports package, $10,327.70.
Oh, dear you. Now, each package represents a different prize. You know three of those packages have boats. There's big cash prizes up there. There's cars up there. There's furs up there. There's trips up there. There's some real clunks up there, dearie. You watch out for those. And don't forget the big treasure hunt daddy of them all. Someplace up there is a check for $25,000, dearie. Go get it. Good luck to you. Pick the one she wants. Jane brings it down. Hi, Jane. Number nine. Why number nine, Delia?
Well, my two children were born in the ninth. My birthday's in the 19th. And my husband's... I forgot.
Okay, Delia. As you know, each package comes with a cash award envelope, and this money is yours to keep unless you decide to give it back for the contents of this package. We're going to find out exactly how much money Delia's won right after time out for these good words.
Gene Rayburn remembers a match game blooper.
I was talking to this beautiful young woman, and I wanted to compliment her on the beauty of her face, and she had two lovely dimples.
Doesn't she have pretty nipples, pretty dimples there?
I was just frozen.
This lady has very pretty dimples in her cheeks, doesn't she?
I got a check from some station in London saying we used your blooper.
Get in on the fun. Watch Game Show Network.
Welcome back to the new treasure hunt. Delia, let's open that envelope, shall we, and see how much you've won. Okay. Take a look here, and we find out of the red envelope comes $1,375. $1,375. And I should pay you off right now. Look, I can see your mind going around already. Would you put your hand out there, please? 100, 200, 300, 400, 500, 600, 700, 800, 900, 1,000, 100, 200, 300, and 50. Wait a minute. There we are. 75. $1,375. And Delia, that money is all yours. You can keep it, or you can give it back to me for the contents of this box. Could be something good in here. Could be a clunk. Could be $25,000 in cash. And now, Delia, it's up to you to make up your mind. The bucks to the box. She said she wants the money. Well, there's a lot of people shaking their heads, Delia.
I need the money.
Well, all right, you got the money. It certainly is yours, but you passed up something in this box.
Oh.
Now, let's see what you passed up. Your daughter says, is it good? Oh, Delia. Boy, I hate to do this. I really do. But you do have the money, right?
Mm-hmm.
So that's something.
Yes.
Okay. Because you would have won. You hear a sound in there? Well, first of all, you would have won a baby bonnet.
Let's put that on.
Right there. There you are. That's kind of cute, isn't it? There's more in the box, though. Don't get your hopes up yet. Because You also would have won a rattle. And there's more in the box. You also passed up a pacifier. Now, it may have been a while since you've had one of these, Delia. Yes. Brings back great memories, doesn't it?
Sure does.
You probably wonder what all that would have meant to you, right? The reason I wanted you to dress up like that, of course, you passed up all of this, but there was a reason for it. Mm-hmm. And I'm kind of sorry that you kept the money, because I have always wanted to say, baby, let's take a spin in your shiny, brand new, super deluxe convertible that's right up there.
Delia, baby, you'd have saved a fortune on gas as you tore down the open sidewalks in this cozy convertible carriage built for the comfort of big, beautiful babies like you. Retail value, $74.99.
That was your clunk. You kept the money. You made the right choice, Delia. Congratulations. Thank you for being with us here on the new treasure hunt. And while we're on the subject, Johnny Jacobs has a few treasures in store for our runners-up for game one. John?
From Anchor Hocking, a hospitality package including beverage, wear for entertainment, and lustrous Vienna lace dinnerware for eight. Plus, the Schick Fresh Air Machine eliminates household odors, keeps your home smelling fresh and clean. Aerosol refills available in three fresh air scents. And True Test Supreme Interior Latex Paint from True Value Hardware Stores, who combine value and personal service in over 4,000 locations nationwide. An assortment of Turtle Wax car care products, including the world's first self-polishing car wax. Just wipe it on, no rubbing, no buffing. From Turtle Wax. And now, back to Jeff Edwards and the new treasure hunt.
Now we're all set for game two. We just saw somebody have a narrow escape. Let's see what's going to happen this time. Everybody in this section, please hold up your boxes so we can see them. There they are. Again, three of those 10 boxes contain the cards with the numbers 1, 2, and 3. If your box has a number, we want you to please stand up. Are you ready? Open your boxes. Good luck. Open them up. You have a number? Stand right up. There's one. Two. To a third. One more coming around. There it is. There's number three. Right over here, please. Here she comes. Let her out, please. Let her out. Like the lady out. Here she comes down. All right. Now we have our three lucky girls. And it's time to choose the boxes. You have number one. I thought you were never going to get down here. Which one would you like? I'll bring it to you.
Oh, let's see.
That one there. All right, you have that one. I'll bring it right over here to you. Who had number two? You had number two. Which one would you like? This one here. That is yours, and you get the one in the middle. Right like that, because you had number three. Now, as you know, there's a surprise in one of these many treasure boxes, and the one of you who gets that surprise is going to try to find television's richest treasure. So, I will get rid of the hooks here and unhook them, and you get ready to open your boxes. Are you ready? Open your boxes. Here we go. There it is. You're going on a treasure hunt for $25,000. You other two ladies, please take your treasure boxes back to your seats. You can exchange them later for some nice gifts. Whoopee. Hello.
Hello.
What's your name?
Danielle.
Danielle what?
Mullen.
Danielle Mullen, how are you tonight, all right?
Fine.
Good. You're our lucky lady. You're a married lady, are you?
Yes.
I would have hardly known that, Danielle. Do you have any children?
Yes, six.
You have six children? I could have guessed that. Well, all right, Danielle, you're our winner. In a minute, you're going to choose one of those packages up there. It could be a jackpot, or it could be a clunk, or it could be $25,000 in cash. But before you make your choice, we're going to show you some of the prizes you could win. For instance, Danielle, you could win this.
It's Open Roads New Hudson, a 19-foot travel trailer, completely self-contained, luxuriously furnished from bath to kitchen, sleeps up to six. It's more like home when you take to the open road. And here are two exciting Hodaka Combat Wombat motorcycles. In addition, you'll choose $500 worth of camping equipment of your choice from the famous Spiegel catalog. Total value of this special treasure hunt sports showcase, $6,263.70.
Hey, I'll tell you something else, Danielle. One of those packages up there contains this.
It's a double showcase in one, two, super shiny. Chevy Vega is the most honored little car built in America, winner of 6 big honors in 3 short years. See what it's like to drive a winner. Chevrolet makes sense for America. These two beauties, plus a special added surprise, boosting the value of this showcase to a grand total of $7,940.06.
And not only that, but you make the right choice, and you're going to find out that one of those packages contains this.
Back by popular demand, here comes the world-famous treasure hunt goose. You may recall this goose lays golden eggs, and tonight her golden gift contains this precious gem. From J. Ortman Jewelers, a unique 18-karat gold necklace wrought in diamonds and white enamel, a very special European design from J. Ortman Jewelers, New York. This necklace, plus 4 other fantastic surprises for a total retail value of $15,922.
Thank you, Stevie. Danielle, that's just a smattering of the prizes up there. Each package represents a different prize, and some of those packages, as you know, contain some extra added surprises. Now, don't forget, somewhere up there amongst the cars, and there's cars up there, and boats, and furs, and trips, and clunks. We saw a lady narrowly miss a clunk. There's a big fat check for $25,000. I hope you find it. Good luck. Number 2. Thank you, Jane. There it is. There is number 2. It didn't take you but a second to pick that out. You were all ready for that.
I have a set of twins, and I just... 2. That's it.
Okay, 2 for the twins. All right, let's find out if it's a lucky package. As you know, already it's lucky because each envelope has a cash award envelope. Each package has a cash award envelope. That's what I want to say. And that money is yours to keep unless you decide to give it back to me. And for the contents of this box, we're going to find... You've got me all confused, Daniel. We're going to find out how much cash you have right after these words.
He said, she said. Who's right? Bert Convy finds out who are the tattletales next on Game Show Network.
Welcome back to the new treasure hunt. And now, Danielle, the time has come to find out how much cash is in your envelope. And you have won $1,330. $1,330. I'll reach into the magic money pocket. Would you put your hand there, please? There is a $1,000 bill. $100, $200. $300, $310, $330. $1,330. You're wrinkling your nose at all that money.
Looks nice.
I bet it does. Well, it's all your money, Danielle. It's all your money. You can keep it, or you can give it back to me for the contents of this box. Could be something good in here. Could be a clunk. Could be $25,000 in cash. But it's your decision. Are you going to keep the money, or are you going to take the box?
I'm going to take the box.
That was the fastest decision I've ever seen on this show. Okay, you own what is in this box, and now comes the time. $1,330. My gracious me. Danielle,
yes.
You took a chance. And it may have paid off for you. Because in this box, there's an Italian dictionary.
Oh, good.
But that's not all. Don't clap yet. Because you're French? There's a French dictionary.
I'm Indian.
You're Indian? Okay. There's a Dutch dictionary. Now, that has a very special meaning. A French dictionary. Do you speak French?
Je vous aime beaucoup.
She speaks French. There's an Italian dictionary. Do you speak Italian?
Mm-hmm.
Well, you can learn Italian. And a Dutch dictionary. I want you to learn Dutch and Italian and keep your French because you are going to teach those words to a parrot. And here it is.
From deep in the teeming jungles of the Amazon comes this cage full of chuckles and squawks, your very own festive and feathered clunk, retail value,
$49.95.
Oh, too bad. Well, that's at least that'll be a fun pet for your kids, your six kids. So take your parrot and your books, and that's what you've got. And Danielle, you're a good sport. Thank you very much. It's kind of heavy. Keep going back to your seat, and I'll bring it back later. Thanks. A nice hand for Danielle. Okay. And now Johnny Jacobs will tell us. Wait a minute. Wait a minute. There's something else in the box. There is something else in this box. I'm sorry, I could have sworn. Just one second, put those books down, because also in this box for you and your parrot are crackers! That's in case your parrot wants to eat. Polly want a cracker? Also, something else is a newspaper! And you can put that in the bottom of the cage in case the parrot wants to read or anything. Not only that, Danielle, now we've played around with you long enough, because in this box also is some green stuff. I'm telling you, there is some cold, hard, green stuff for the parrot. And there you are, Danielle. You got your crackers, a newspaper, and some cold, hard, green stuff. And just one more thing. This parrot eats sunflower seeds. You know about birds at all?
No, I used to have some parakeets, but that was a long time.
Well, this one eats sunflower seeds, and we want you to have enough sunflower seeds to feed this parrot the rest of his life, and he'll have a long lifetime. So in order to purchase those sunflower seeds, there's $8,000! Playing the game with us tonight, and now it's time to find out where the $25,000 is. But first, here's Johnny Jacobs with some gifts for our winner of guests for game two. John?
Here's DuPont Super Scrub. It's a sponge, it's a scrubber, it's a sponge that scrubs like a brush. DuPont Super Scrub. Plus Plumber Saver, the double-action drain opener with over twice the active ingredients. Plumber Saver. And Pez Candy Dispensers, the new novel pop-out candy dispenser in a wide selection of popular cartoon characters. Refills, too. Pez at candy counters everywhere. And here's Eagle's handsomely tailored men's sports coat. It's a plaid where a plaid should be plaid. Eagle Clothes, a distinguished fashion leader in suits, sports coats, and slacks. Now back to Jeff Edwards and the new treasure hunt.
Well, it's been some night on the new treasure hunt. We've seen all sorts of things happen. So a lucky winner with the $8,000. And now it's time to find out exactly where the $25,000 is hidden. This gentleman, I know you know him by now, our bonded security agent, Mr. Emil Arturi. How you doing, Mr. Arturi? Mr. Arturi, will you verify the fact that you did hide the check?
Yes, I did, Jeff.
Thank you, Mr. Arturi. Where do you think it is? Somebody said 21. Look at that. 21 is exactly where it is. And we look inside box number 21 and we come up with $25,000. Boy, if anybody had picked 21, they would have $25,000 right now, but they didn't. And so that goes back to Mr. Emil Arturi for safekeeping. And next week, two more lucky players are going to have a chance to go on a treasure hunt with the possibility of winning $25,000 in cash. And until then, this is Jeff Edwards wishing you good luck. Good night.
Storage furnished by Global Van Lines. Planning to move? Whether around the corner or around the world, call Global for modern moving with old-fashioned care. DuPont, Anchor Hocking, Daisies, Turtle Wax, Pez, Schick, True Value, and Eagle also furnish prizes. We'll be right back. The New Treasure Hunt is a production of Chuck Barris Creations.
Ladies and gentlemen, this bonded security agent has just placed a certified check for $50,000 in one of these 66 surprise packages. Today, someone may win any one of our fabulous prizes, or that grand prize of $50,000 on Treasure Hunt. From Hollywood, it's Treasure Hunt. Here's the star of our show, Jeff Edwards.
Welcome to Treasure Hunt, the television show with 66 prize packages. One of those packages today contains a check for $50,000. And now, ladies and gentlemen, let's welcome back our continuing winner. This is Rose Evans. How you doing, Rose?
Good.
Rose, this is your third day with us. So far, you've won $7,976.90 in cash and prizes. But right now, it's time to find a new challenger for you, so you stay right there. As you know, we pre-selected members of our studio audience to participate in game one. So everybody in this section, please hold up your balloon so we can see them. Hold them up good and high. If your balloon has a star, we want you to please stand up. So place your balloons on your laps and pop those balloons. Here we go. Looking for that star. Come on down. There you go. Now, as you know, there's a pop-up surprise in one of these mini treasure boxes. One of you who gets that surprise is going to try to find our richest treasure. Our new challenger always gets first choice. Which box would you like? This is yours. All right, Rose, this is yours. I'll undo the hooks. Ready to open your boxes? Open the boxes. Rose, you did it again! You take your box, watch it. Take your box back and see if you can trade it later for some good prizes. Rose?
Hey! Hey! Oh, you smell good. You smell so good.
Well, don't get carried away with it. As you know, Rose, you can go on winning and winning as long as you keep picking the mini treasure box of the pop-up surprise. In a minute, you're going to walk up there behind me. You're going to choose a package, and that package could represent anything from a real clunk to a jackpot of prizes, or it could be our grand prize of $50,000 in cash. But before you make your choice, we're going to show you some of the surprises waiting for you here on Treasure Hunt. Rose, for example, you could go on to win this.
Brent the Furrier, New York's largest furrier, presents this magnificent dyed Norwegian shadow fox full-length coat, lavishly accented with a sumptuous shawl collar. It can be worn loose or fitted. The drama this Brent the Furrier fur will make any woman feel like a star. Total retail value of this spectacular full-length fur coat, $2,995.
That's nice, sure. Or, Rose, you could go on to win this.
You and a guest might join Delta Line crews on their fabulous 52-day South American sailing vacation. Visit 15 exotic ports, luxurious accommodations, and pampered treatment. All yours aboard your Delta Line cruise. This fabulous trip plus two added surprises for a total retail value of $18,441.
Oh, Rose, that'd be great. Now, remember, there's some mean old clunks up there. What, you remember what a clunk is?
Yeah.
What's a clunk?
So funny, a good thing.
That what? A clunk is something not so good, remember?
Yeah.
All right, so watch out for the clunks. But also, you might find furs and trips, and don't forget that big treasure hunt, daddy of them all. Someplace up there, Rose, has a check for $50,000. Go get it. Good luck. Okay, Rose, come on back. What number did you pick?
Eight.
Box number eight. Why eight?
I just love eight.
You love eight. Well, well, each number so far has been lucky for you, and here comes box number eight. As you know, each package comes with a cash award envelope. That money is yours to keep unless you decide to give it back to me for the contents of this package. We'll find out what her cash award is right after this message. Okay, welcome back to Treasure Hunt. Now, Rose, let's open the envelope and see how much money you've won. You ready?
Yeah.
This time you have $920. $920, Rose. That's all your money? All right, come right up here. I'll pay you off. Ready?
Yeah, I'm ready.
All right. 100, 200, 300, 400, 500, 600, 700, 800, 900, 910, $920. $920, Rose. Now you know. You can keep that money or you can give it back to me for the contents of this package. Could be something good, could be a clunk, could be $50,000. So now, Rose, what are you going to do? Rose says she's going to take the box. $920.
Information. Call now 1-800-220-9965. That's 1-800-220-9965.
Okay, welcome back to Treasure Hunt. Now, Rose, let's open the envelope and see how much money you've won. You ready?
Yeah.
This time you have $920. $920, Rose. That's all your money. All right, come right up here. I'll pay you off. Ready?
Yeah, I'm ready.
All right. 100, 200, 300, 400, 500, 600, 700, 800, 900. $910, $920, $920, Rose, now you know. You can keep that money or you can give it back to me for the contents of this package. Could be something good, could be a clunk, could be $50,000. So now, Rose, what are you going to do? Rose says she's going to take the box. $920. The first time, and Rose, this is about, what, the fourth time you've done this?
Yeah.
The first time you took the money, just like that?
Yeah.
Then each time after that, you took the box?
Yeah.
Do you get a feeling or something, or what? Huh? A Jamaica feeling? Is that what he said?
Yeah.
Is that what it is?
Yeah.
Okay. A Jamaica feeling.
Feeling.
Jamaica feeling.
Reggae.
Reggae, yeah. Did you make a mistake? Did you make a feeling? Did you make a mistake?
Yeah.
Get that?
Yeah.
How strong a Jamaica feeling?
Very strong.
Really strong?
Really strong. Could lift the walls, tear the whole place apart.
Well, Rose.
Heavy, eh?
No, it's not heavy. I could lift it with two hands. Rose, you gave up $920. You're applauding that?
Yeah.
And that's almost $1,000.
Yeah.
And you own what is in that box. Now, you have not been clunked yet at all on this show, have you?
No.
You know what a clunk is?
Yeah.
Say clunk.
Clunk.
What is a clunk?
Little animal. I forgot.
What? No, you can't forget what a clunk is. A clunk is something bad.
Oh, something bad.
Well, okay. I can tell you that this is not a clunk.
What is that?
It's a piece of paper.
Oh, come on.
And on that piece of paper, it says, Rose, that you have won $50,000!
check.
You take this check right here, and we'll be back in just a few moments. Welcome back to Treasure Hunt. If you just tuned in, our champion, Rose Evans, just hit us for $50,000. All right. As you know, we started with $20,000. It grew by $1,000 leaps every day till it got to be 50, and so we're starting all over again, and Emil Aturi has hidden another check, this time for $20,000 in one of those prize packages, and now we need a new challenger for Rose Evans. So will all of you in this section please hold up your balloons, hold them up good and high so we can see them. One of those balloons contains a star. If your balloon has a star, we want you to please stand up. So put your balloons on your laps and pop those balloons. Looking for a star. If you have a star, stand right up. Okay, there it is. Come on down. Right here, please. And as you already know, there's a pop-up surprise in one of these many treasure boxes. One of you who gets that surprise is going to go on a treasure hunt. You have the star. You get first choice. Which box would you like? This one here. All right, that is yours. Rose, this is yours. Put your hands in your boxes. Open your boxes. There it is. You're going in the treasure hunt for $50,000. Rose, we say goodbye to you. You go home with $57,976.90 in cash. Spend that money well. Hope you get back to Jamaica. Bye-bye. Big hand for Rose Evans, our champion. Right up there is fine. Can you come over here, please? Okay. Now, we start all over again. What's your name?
Joanne Polo.
Where are you from, Joanne?
Originally from Tampa, Florida. Moved to Dallas, Texas.
So you're from Dallas now?
Yeah.
You live in Dallas now?
Outside of Dallas.
Okay, Joanne, fine. In just a minute, you're going to choose one of those packages up there behind us. As you know, it could be a clunk. You also know it could be a lot of money, $20,000 waiting in one of those packages. But before you make your choice, we're going to show you some of our fabulous prizes. For example, you could go on to win this.
It's a brand new Chevette two-door hatchback coupe. Featuring a 1.6-liter two-barrel L4 engine, a four-speed manual transmission, and white wall tires, the Chevette hatchback coupe. One tough son of a gun from Schoenlaw Chevrolet Hollywood. Total retail value of this magnificent automobile, $5,385.85.
Now, you know, Rose got herself $50,000. Well, it wasn't too long ago somebody else hit us for some big money, and if you're really lucky, something like this could happen to you. Take a look. What you have is a check for $23,000! And don't forget, somewhere up there among the clunks, the cars, the furs, the jewels, the furniture, and the trips is a big fat check for $20,000. Go get it and good luck to you. All right, come on back. Box number 49. Jan, bring it down. Come on back down. Why 49?
It just stuck out.
49 stuck out. Well, okay. As you know, each package comes with a cash reward envelope. That's your money to keep unless you decide to give it back to me for the contents of this package, and we'll find out how much cash that is right after these messages. And welcome back to Treasure Hunt, and now the time has come to find out how much cash is in your envelope. Are you all set?
Yes.
All right. You have won $860. $860? I'll pay you off right now, Joanne. Here we go. 100, 200, 300, 400, 500, 600, 700, 800, 850, $860. $860. Now comes the toughest decision of all. What do? Do you keep the bucks or you take the box? Could be something good, could be a clunk, could be $20,000 in cash. So what are you going to do, Joanne? You take the bucks or the box?
The box.
The box. She says the box. I take back the money, $860 right there. You want to say goodbye to him?
Yeah. Bye.
Bye.
Money talks, they say. Now, let's see what it is that you now own.
Don't make me wait.
Huh?
Don't make me wait.
Oh, I'm sorry. Were you waiting?
Yes.
I'm so sorry. You want to see?
Yes.
Here. Okay. In this box is just one thing. And that one thing is in my hand. Do you get it? Yes, you'll get it. You gave up $860 and you won this police whistle. You know, I've seen some chintzy clunks on this show. This is the worst of all. And what a dumb thing. What?
That's really the pits.
It is the pits. That's terrible. I tell you what, maybe if you blow this police whistle, maybe there'll be something more to your prize. Maybe you win something else. You want to give it a try?
Badly.
All right, blow it good and loud. Maybe you didn't blow it loud enough.
Well, again?
Yeah. That's really good and loud. That ought to do it.
I hope so.
There it is. Look at that.
Blowing his ear, and he'll follow you anywhere. Your very own cute, cuddly, and very racy teddy bear with best wishes from Treasure Hunt. Total retail value, $30.
Well, yeah. You blew in his ear, and all you got was this racy-looking teddy bear. It's the raciest bear I've ever seen. Except, no, that's not true. I was in Le Mans, and I saw a bear. It was a lot racier than this. He took a hairpin curve on one wheel, right? So that was really a racy bear. I'll tell you what. You're going to want to drive this bear home in the kind of vehicle that he's used to. And that vehicle is waiting for you right up there.
Yes, Joanne, it's a finely tuned high-performance unicycle. Only one tire to change, no gas problems, no license, no tax, and nobody left on third. Total value of your bear and unicycle, $75.95.
Well, it looks like you got clunked, and that's too bad. But you'll be back with us on Treasure Hunt again tomorrow. You're still our champion. I'll have a chance to go on another Treasure Hunt looking for that $20,000. But right now, it's time to find out where the $20,000 is hidden. First, here's Johnny Jacobs with some gifts for our runners-up. John?
Some of our contestants will receive new odor-free Exocane for fast temporary relief from arthritis pain without odor heater stains. New odor-free Exocane. And get the full-size Speedolite iron from Hamilton Beach. You'll never run out of steam. From Hamilton Beach, Scoville, with 70 years of quality. And Ragu's Pizza Quick Sauce is specially made to turn bread into fresh hot pizza. Open a jar of Pizza Quick Sauce and open your own pizzeria. Here's Jeff Edwards.
Welcome back to Treasure Hunt. In case you missed the beginning of this show, this lady is Rose Evans from Canada, originally from Jamaica, and she won herself $50,000. Rose, it's great because you've been the champion on the show for 3 or 4 days. You've just been doing really great things. All of a sudden, there you say, I have the Jamaica feeling, and you picked the box and got the $50,000. What are you going to do with the money?
I'm going to go to Jamaica, and I'm going to build my own home. Four bedroom.
Terrific.
In Jamaica, on the North Coast.
On where?
On the North Coast.
Okay, on the North Coast? Yeah. And then you're going to live there, are you, and stay there?
Yeah. Oh, I'm going to stay there.
Can I come visit you when I come
to Jamaica?
Sure. Okay. Yeah. Well, if you want to take a look and see what you look like when you got the $50,000, and we'll ask you to take a look at, too, in case you missed it. This is Rose Evans when she found out she won $50,000. I can tell you that this is not a clunk. It's a piece of paper.
Oh, come on.
And on that piece of paper, it says, Rose, that you have won $50,000.
Oh,
Well, boy, that was really something, wasn't it? What a nice lady, too. I'm just delighted that she has that money. Well, then in the middle of the show, Emil Alturi hit a check for $20,000. That's our beginning amount. And this is our bonded security agent, Mr. Emil Alturi. Well, we... He hates it when they win. He just hates it when they win. Look, he is furious. Inside, this man is seething. Okay, Emil, will you verify the fact you did hide the check for $20,000?
Yes, I did.
Okay. Where do you think it was this time? Number 11. 11 is where it was, box number 11. We'll bring that down and take a look in there. And indeed, there is a check for $20,000 in cash. Maybe somebody will pick this up tomorrow. We'll find out. Till tomorrow, this is Jeff Edwards wishing you good luck and goodbye.
From Hollywood, the dating capital of the world, it's the new dating game. And here's the exciting voice of the talented Miss Julie Budd.
If you're feeling sad and lonely, there's a service I can render. Tell the one who loves you only, I can be so warm and tender.
We'll be calling upon one of three bachelors tonight when she plays the new dating game. And now, here's your host, the star of the new dating game, Jim Lang.
Thank you. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you, Johnny. Well, the delightful Miss Julie Budd will be joining us in tonight's game two, but we have another special treat coming up right now in game one, as one of our favorite funny men, Richard Dawson, takes his dating druthers from a trio of most delectable young bachelorettes. So let's meet that delightful threesome right now. And here are the ladies. Welcome, girls. Welcome. Desirable damsel number one is an account executive for an advertising firm. She's writing a book. She's an ex-stewardess. She's lived in Kansas City and Denver. I'd like you to meet June Tongue. June, welcome. Good luck. Our second lovely lady has won many beauty titles. She is an actress, she is a singer, she is a model, and she's done lots of film and television work. Her name is Karen Lindsay. Karen, welcome.
And our third gorgeous gal is a fashion coordinator for a retail ladies store right now. She loves all outdoor sports, and her name is Gelda Cena. Gelda, welcome to you. And there they are. Those are the three pretty ladies for the clever comedian in tonight's game number one. Now, to prevent our special guest from hearing the introductions of our three ladies, of course, we've been keeping him isolated, offstage in a soundproof booth. Let's bring him on stage right now. He was one of the comedy stars of the past seasons of Laugh-In. He's seen regularly on the new Match Game, the Merv Griffin Show, and I've Got a Secret. He's a native of England. My great pleasure to welcome to the dating game, Richard Dawson. Hello, Richard.
How are you?
I'm fine. You look great. You've got a tan and everything. It's beautiful.
Card.
Your card, it's the Joker, yes.
Forever in the Valley, come and see me.
All right, well, we have three ladies. On the other side of the partition, new dating game is just about the same. You ask the questions, you listen to the answers, you make a choice, and you meet your date, and we tell you where you're going to go, all right?
It's a deal.
All right, let's start with a hello. Bachelorette number one, would you please say good evening to Richard?
Good evening, Richard.
How about number two?
Good evening, Richard.
And Bachelorette number three?
Good evening, Richard.
All right, Richard, you all set?
Certainly.
All right, Ollie, have a seat. Make yourself comfortable. Got your card?
Yep.
All right, we're ready to go. Ladies, stand by. This is it.
Bachelorette number one. Stay the secret wait in my apartment and a duck will come down with $100 for our date. Now, what's the secret wait?
Peanuttiest? that's all I'd say.
It's amazing I have an amnesia victim for a guest. All right, Bachelorette number three. What do you think the secret word is?
Open sesame.
Well, I'll certainly accept that until another word comes along. Bachelorette number two. Now, it's our first date. What is it going to be like? Championship wrestling or Saturday night at the fights?
I don't care for either one, Richard. I'm sorry. You're going to have to think up something more romantic for me.
Well, I certainly didn't come here to be insulted. All right, Bachelorette number three. Would we wrestle or would we fight?
We'd wrestle.
Well, so far, she has an edge on everything. Keep the rosin bag handy. Bachelorette number one. If you had to make a choice, my dear, between a handsome, devil-may-care, suave man about town, a person who is a dancer, raconteur, linguist, artiste, an all-round good fellow like myself, or you have to choose that ne'er-do-well rascallion, that scallywag of the airwaves, James Bonnyface Lang.
Aww.
Who would you choose and why?
I'm a little chickadee. Kick a kid down the street every day for kicks.
Well,
I think I'd choose you.
My dear, we're on the way to glory.
What?
Just as well. There's a lot of the tomboy in young James.
Couldn't I?
All right, Bachelorette number two. I like different things about different women. So what's the big difference between Bachelorette number one and Bachelorette number three?
Height.
She's a brilliant conversationalist.
Yes.
A trifle limited, but brilliant. Bachelorette number three. I happen to be in favor of women's lip, but I expect women to do their share of making the first move. Now, I'm at a party surrounded by very beautiful women. How would you go about picking me up?
I don't think I'd have any problem at all. I'm a very aggressive lady.
You're very aggressive?
I don't think I'd have any problem at all.
Well, how would you go about it, darling?
I would just walk up and take over.
You're not a policewoman, are you?
Not hardly.
No, because I'm double parked. I wanted to check. All right, Bachelorette number one, how would you go about picking me up at a party?
I would be the duck that came down from the ceiling with a $100 bill in its mouth.
Well, every person to his choice. Bachelorette number two. Tell me three bad things about you that I might find attractive.
Well, I have flat feet. My mother says that I have a greater understanding, though. So that's one thing. Bad things? No, I really can't think of any more. That's the only bad thing I can think of.
They're always losers, the girls who have nothing wrong. All right, Bachelorette number three. three bad things about you I might find attractive.
Well, I'm not sure whether you'd find them all attractive or not. From time to time, I'm very talkative. I kind of have a tendency to take over.
That's it. That's the signal, Richard. Now, you have a short time to make up your mind. Think about it. Girls, stand by. And while Richard is deciding which one of the bachelorettes he's going to select for his date, we'll take a little time out for these words for you. Watch. Welcome back to the dating game, and Richard, this is it. You're going to choose one of those lovely ladies as your date, and of course, that decision is totally yours. The question is, will it be bachelorette number one, bachelorette number two, or bachelorette number three? Who is that very lucky gal?
Well, I've thought it over.
Yes.
The young lady I think who did Mae West so well. Bachelorette number uno.
Number one. All right. Bachelorette number one. Congratulations. They're all there. Well, I'll tell you what. Before you meet your date, I think it could only be fair to meet the other two ladies first. Bachelorette number two has won many beauty titles. She is a singer and she is a model. I'd like you to meet Karen Lindsay. Karen, say hi to Richard Dawson, if you would, please. Thank you very much, Karen. Did a marvelous job. You also didn't choose number three. No, Richard. She's a fashion coordinator for a retail ladies store right now. She loves all outdoor sports. And she's talkative, she said. Her name is Gelda Sena. Gelda, come on and say hi to Richard, if you would, please. Thank you, Gelda. And now your date. Are you ready?
Yes, yes.
All right, I'll tell you a little bit about number one. She's an account executive for an advertising firm right now. She's also writing a book. She lived in Denver and Kansas City. And, of course, right now here, her name is June Tongish. June, say hi to Richard Dawson. Your date. Well, Richard and June, there may be tennis doubles and daily doubles, but we have a real dating double lined up for your date that will first take you to the big town of New York City. That's right. There's excitement awaiting you and your dating dance chaperone in New York City, where you'll attend a performance of the famed Miller Johnson Circus at Singer Bowl in Flushing Meadows. The Miller Johnson Circus represents a return to the rich tradition of the circus as it once was in America, under an orange and white big top, the largest traveling big top in the world. You'll be staying in New York's reigning hotel, the Americana, with 50 gleaming stories right in the center of everything. The Americana boasts three fine restaurants and New York's leading supper club. But don't get too comfortable, because you'll soon be jetting off to beautiful Montreux, Switzerland! That's right. You'll be guests of the Swiss National Tourist Office, and you'll stay at the lovely Euratel Hotel in Montreux, one of the most popular tourist resorts in Switzerland, nestling in two bays at the eastern end of Lake Geneva. From your own private penthouses at the top of the Eurotel, you'll have a magnificent view of the beautiful Swiss landscape, and you'll enjoy the covered heated pool and sauna and massage facilities, along with delicious dining at the Rocher Danay, a charming mountain restaurant. And to make your trip even more exciting, here are your very own ski boots for you to show. And they're not just ordinary boots for the ordinary skier, because these are O'Brien's, introducing the Big O, offering the little something extra that's so important. Built for the most comfortable fit that can be found, featuring dual buckles and bright colors, O'Brien offers the utmost in performance and pleasure. I know you'll have a great time in Switzerland. You're certainly welcome. It's a pleasure to shake your foot.
Thank you.
Thank you, Richard. Have a good time. All right. Well, game two will be bringing us the delightful Miss Julie Budd, a young lady whose singing career began at the age of 13, but Julie's a little older now, and certainly she's romantically wiser, as we'll see. Thank you, and welcome back. Well, now we each hoping to strike a note of love in the heart of a charming young lady of song, our three most hopeful young bachelors. So let's meet them right now, and here they are. Welcome, gentlemen. All right, bachelor number one is currently working as a hotel desk clerk. He wants to study mime with Marcel Marceau, and he admits to having been named the cutest baby in his hometown of Broken Arrow, Oklahoma. Meet Tony Brown. Tony, welcome to the show. A future lawyer, bachelor number two is now studying history at Northeastern State College in Oklahoma. He's won athletic honors. He hails from Cushing, Oklahoma. Here is Rick Keith. Rick, welcome to the dating game. And bachelor number three is in the record promotion field. He enjoys photography and tennis. He also skis and plays the guitar. And New York City was his birthplace. Please welcome Stephen Geller. Stephen, welcome to you. All right, those are the three bright bachelor boys for tonight's game number two. Of course, to prevent our special young lady from hearing the introductions of our three gentlemen, we've been keeping her isolated, offstage in a soundproof room. Let's bring her on stage right now. She's performed for standing room only audiences in such places as Long Island's Westbury Music Fair and New York's Lincoln Center. And she's been seen on top television variety shows from New York City. Please join me in welcoming to the new dating game, the very talented Miss Julie Budd. Hello, Julie. Oh, you sang so great at the opening. I loved it. Now, Julie, we're going to ask the bachelors to do a little singing or talking or whatever to find out a little more about them. You have your questions ready, I presume, okay? You listen carefully to the answers, then you make your decision when it's all over. Those are the rules. Very simple. We start with a hello. Bachelor number one, would you say good evening to Julie, please?
Hello, Julie.
How about number two?
Just a second. I'll get the peanut butter out of my mouth. Hello, Julie.
Okay. And number three?
Hi, Julie.
All right, they're all ready. All set? Please have a seat, Julie. Make yourself comfortable. Bachelors, stand by. Listen carefully. Good luck to everybody, and here we go.
Bachelor number one, I'm not going to pick you because of your answers. So to convince me to pick you out of pity.
I can't really. I'd like to come up and talk to you, but I only have one leg, and I would like to show you what I'm doing. Wait a minute, I'll limp over.
No, don't strain yourself. Bachelor number two, how about you?
Well, you want to repeat that? I didn't hear that.
Okay. Oh, is that one of the deformities?
Will repeat that again?
Bachelor number two, I'm not going to pick you because of your answers, so convince me to pick you out of pity.
Number two.
Yeah.
Do what?
She just repeated
no,
the question
really.
For
that's the
deformities. My deformities are quite unique. I've got one eye in the middle of my head. And, my ears are kind of funny, too. They're long and pointed. And they walk, you know, I had this poem about stepping on my ears. I really like to hear all the good things about you, though.
Number one is much more pitiful.
Mm-hmm. Thank
you. Number three, I'm basically a home buddy, so give me three good reasons why I should let you take my body home.
Because I need a lot of help in the kitchen. I just moved into my new house, and we need a lot of help around the house.
Uh-huh.
And you would surely be a terrific addition to the house.
Right. How about you, bachelor number one?
Well, I can think of three good reasons. One is that I need a girl around the house to wash the dishes. I need a girl to answer the phone.
Uh-huh.
And I also need a girl to cook cornbread.
Why don't you just get a maid?
Well, maids, I hire male maids. I need girls for other things.
Oh, I see. Bachelor number two, why is it when I dream about you at night, I wake up laughing?
Well, it's about eye and them two ears.
That's great. Yeah, no. That'll do it. Bachelor number three?
I think you're probably laughing at bachelor number two. You wouldn't be laughing at me.
Oh, no?
No.
Okay, bachelor number one.
Yes?
Most delicatessens cater affairs. With what would a delicatessen cater our first affair?
Well, they would bring 5 tons of corned beef, throw it in the middle of the floor. I'd have a guy pop out of the middle of it, and we'd have a big orgy in the middle of the corned beef.
That's really disgusting.
Thank you. Thank you.
Bachelor number two, can you do any better?
Yeah, I sure can. I'd like, he'd come out with this big platter, and underneath, when he lifts it up, there'd be a sign that says TLC, Tender Loving Care, and that's what we'd have for dinner.
That's not bad. That's not bad. Number three, give me all the adjectives you need to describe your body.
Thrilling.
Huh?
Beautiful. Scrumptious.
Not bad.
Dark.
How would you describe number ones?
Prodigious.
Prodigious. All right, that's it, Julie. Game's over. Now all you have to do is decide. So relax and think about it. While Julie's taking a short while to decide which of our three mystery bachelors will be her choice for a big swinging date, we'll take a little time out to listen to this message. Watch. Welcome back to the dating game, the new dating game, Julie Budd, and it's time for you to make that decision. Now, will your date be bachelor number one, bachelor number two, or bachelor number three? Julie, who's the lucky guy?
Bachelor number one.
Number one, all right. Number one is the lucky one. Is there any reason? Any reason, Julie?
I'll help him hop along.
You're going to help him hop along with his one leg. All right, well, we'll meet them all individually. First, number two is a future lawyer studying history at Northeastern State College in Oklahoma. You might have caught the accent there, Rick Keith. Rick, come on and say hi to Julie Budd, if you would, please. Thanks, Rick. You also didn't choose number three. He's in the record promotion field, enjoys skiing, plays the guitar. He's from New York City, too, Stephen Geller. Steve, come on and say hi to Julie, if you would. Thank you, Steve. And now your date, Julie, number one, and I'll tell you something about him. He wants to study mime with Marcel Marceau, so if conversation lags, he can act it out. He's named the cutest baby in his hometown, which was Broken Arrow, Oklahoma, Tony Brown. Tony, come on and say hi to Julie. Congratulations, Tony. Well, Julie, you opened the show with a great rendition of the song Call Me. And now you and Tony are going to be answering a great call, the call of the high seas, because you'll be leaving on a date that will take you on a seven-day-long cruise to the beautiful Caribbean Sea. That's right. You and your dating game chaperone will be flying to Miami, Florida, where you'll board the luxurious TSS Mardi Gras Panamanian Registry to visit some of the most romantic ports of call in the whole world, such as St. Thomas in the Virgin Islands, San Juan, Puerto Rico, and Nassau in the Bahamas. And you'll love the fine accommodations aboard the TSS Mardi Gras with a whole host of fun-filled shipboard activities and some of the greatest dining imaginable, all in your seven-day-long date on the luxurious TSS Mardi Gras, cruising through the romantic islands of the Caribbean. Have a great time, and thank you both very, very much. Really great. Thanks, Tony. Nice job. We'll see you in a minute. Well, don't forget to join us next week. That's it for tonight. Jim Lang saying thank you, bye-bye, and I hope you always get the date that you really want. Hey, come on in, gang. I don't know. I think if you want to blow the kiss again, get ready. Let's do it again. Come on. Ah, the old pizza.
So you want to play some rock and roll. The first thing you need is a new hairdo and get a whole new style. Develop bad habits. Oh, and don't forget the music lessons. Of course, you could just tune in and play Rock and Roll Jeopardy on Game Show Network.
This game rocks.
Weekends at 12:30 p.m. Eastern, 9:30 a.m. Pacific.
You're single at the time of pre-recording this program. Dating Game is a Chuck Barris production.
Americans just like you compete to have us pay off all their bills and go home with nothing. And now, let's meet today's contestants.
I'm Kelly and I'm in debt because my radio career is temporarily off the air.
I'm Jason and I'm in debt because my wedding bells rang the credit card blues.
I'm Janine and I'm in debt because I buy too many gifts for too many people.
And now, starting at host, the crowd.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Welcome. Thanks, everybody. Welcome to the show. While the country's in debt, you're probably in debt, but most importantly, our three players, Kelly, Jason, and Janine, have come to us with their real-life debt, and one of them just might be lucky enough to get out of it by the end of this very show. Now, before we get started, to make things fair, we always like to do this. We even you all out to the average debt amount of the day. Kelly, Jason, and Janine, your debt comes to $7,262. Our opening question is worth one big dollar. Yes, $1. And also the honor of selecting our first category. For a dollar, I'm the abbreviation on the label of underwear made by Bradley, Voorhees, and Day. Kelly.
BVD.
And I'm wearing mine.
Woo, baby.
Yes. Okay, you're $1 closer to getting out of debt, and you have control of the board.
All right.
Let's look at today's categories for general debt. We are dealing with the Winksters' hot poker tips. Arresting personalities. The periodic table of celebrity elements. Doing it for your country. And finally, mamas, don't let your babies grow up to be Willie Nelson. Now, this is an elimination round. Only the two players with the least debt at the end of the round get to move on and have a chance at going home with...
nothing!
All right, let's get this party started.
Yay!
Now, Kelly, since you got our toss-up question correct, you get to select our first category.
All right, Wink, let's shuffle up and deal. The Winkster's hot poker tip.
Oh, you have good taste. This category is all about terms used when playing poker. For minus $50, I'm the term used for a poker hand all of the same suit and what kids do after they're toilet trained. Jason?
Flush.
Yes, subtract $50 from that man's debt. For minus $100. I'm the term used when a player withdraws his cards out of competition and what you do to see the cool picture on the back cover of Mad Magazine. How about it, Jason?
Fold.
Yes, another $100 deducted from your debt. For $150, I'm the 5 or 7 card poker game with no draw, and I sound like a guy you'd find on an old Mark DiCarlo game show. Kelly.
Stud.
Yes. Remove $150 from that lady's debt. For minus $200. I'm a poker hand containing three of a kind and a pair, and the sitcom that made Jody Sweetin a star. How about it, Janine?
Full House.
Yes. We reduce your debt by $200. Final question for minus $250. I'm a consecutive numerical sequence of 5 cards and the last name of country singer George. Jason.
Straight.
Yes, that eliminates another $250 from your debt. Jason, you answered correctly the last time, so select our next category.
Let's go with arresting personalities, Wayne.
Sounds interesting. These questions are all about stars whose behavior has landed them in jail for minus $50 off your debt. I'm the actor who in 1991 exposed Pee-wee Herman to Pensacola moviegoers. Kelly.
Paul Reubens.
Yes, that cuts your debt by another $50. For minus $100. I'm the Joker who was arrested in 1994 in Los Angeles for taking a 9-iron to the hood of a car. Kelly.
Jack Nicholson.
Yes, once again, that lessens your debt by $100. For $150, I'm the TV taxi driver who did time for punching a security guard, showing him who's the boss. Jason.
Tony Danza.
Yes, yeah. That decreases your debt by $150 for minus $200. I'm the Colorado singer who once got a DUI for driving on a Rocky Mountain high. Jason.
John Denver.
That is right. Eliminating $200 from your debt, moving to the $250 question. Arrested for mooning in 1990, I'm the heavy metal drummer who married the original top-heavy Tool Time girl. How about it, Janine?
Tommy Lee.
Yes, $250 off your debt for that. Select, Janine.
I will take the periodic table of celebrity elements.
You're going to like that because it's our detonator. The most difficult category on today's board, in the opinion of our producers, as I come down. Because of that, the value of each question in this category is double. The answers to these questions are entertainers who share initials with symbols on the periodic table. For minus $100, I'm the once red-hot actor whose initials HG are the symbol for Mercury, and I sure felt the heat drop after starring in Extreme Measures. Kelly.
Hugh Grant.
Yes, $100 reduced from your debt. For minus $200, I'm the Cuban actor who starred in Jennifer 8 on the silver screen, and my initials AG are the symbol for silver. Jason.
Andy Garcia.
Yeah, that cuts $200 from your debt for minus $300. I'm the bass-playing monkey whose initials PT are the symbol for platinum. And my name rhymes with dork. Jason.
Peter Torg.
Yes. That lessens your debt by $300. Big one. For $400 off of it. It's no surprise that my initials AS are the symbol for arsenic. I'm the dopey comic who did my bad song shtick in Mixed Nuts. Janine.
Adam Sandler.
Yes. That lessens your debt by $400. Biggest question of the day for $500 off your debt. Even though I share my one-letter initial with Stinky Sulfur, I'm the sweet-voiced Nigerian singer of Never As Good As The First Time. Jason.
Sade.
Sade is right. $500 off your debt. Select, Jason.
Winklet's doing it for our country.
Okay, these answers are government services. Government services for minus $50. I'm the branch of the military whose commercials ask you to be all that you can be. Kelly.
The Army.
Good for $50 off your debt. For minus $100, answer this. I'm the branch of the military that attracts the few, the proud, and Gomer Pyle. Kelly.
The Marines.
Yes. Another reduction of your debt, $100 for minus $150. I'm the military branch the motley crew of the movie Down Periscope belongs to, and my slogan tells you it's not just a job, it's an adventure. Jason.
The Navy.
Yes, that cuts your debt $150. For minus $200, our business is knowing the world's business. I'm the government agency that Jack Ryan had retired from in Patriot Games. Kelly.
CIA.
Yes, the Central Intelligence Agency. One more question for minus $250. I'm the pacifist-sounding government program established by JFK in the 60s that promises to be the toughest job you'll ever love. Jason.
The Peace Corps.
Yeah, that lessens your debt by another $250. Here's our final category. Mamas, don't let your babies grow up to be Willie Nelson, please. This category is about, as you might imagine, Willie Nelson for minus $50. I'm Willie's 1978 mega album that featured the hit Georgia on My Mind, and I'm the kind of memories Woody Allen had in a 1980 flick. Everything got quiet. Stardust, Stardust, for minus $100. After the ode to all the broken hearts we've left behind, I'm the Spanish crooner who rejoined Willie in 88 to croon Spanish Eyes. Janine.
Julio Iglesias.
That is correct. Good for $100 off your debt. Good for $150 if you answer this. Name Billboard's country and western top western single of the year. I'm Willie's big Grammy-winning 82 crossover hit about somebody he couldn't forget. You Were Always On My Mind was the title. And that sound means it's the end of General Debt, and I'm sorry to say that you, Kelly, you have the highest score. Unfortunately, in our game, that means you're eliminated. But you're not going home empty-handed. Julie, what do we have for Kelly?
Well, Kelly, to help you get back on the road to financial recovery, here's our very own debt piggy bank, along with a $200 savings bond.
So, we'll be back to see Jason and Janine go head-to-head for a chance to pay off all their bills right after we take this break.
And we're back to roll the dice of debt with our pit boss.
Thanks, Julie Claire. Welcome back, everybody. We're down to a couple of players now. Jason, who's in debt because of his wedding expenses, is in the lead with minus $5,112. And Janine, who's in debt because she loves the gift of giving, has minus $6,312. At the end of this round, the player with the least debt remaining will have a chance to have us pay off their entire debt. But first, we're going to play gambling debt. In this round, I'll show you a category, and you'll wager between yourselves to see who can answer the most questions correctly out of five that I'll read. Category values increase throughout the round. $300 will be at stake on our first category, which is colleges where size is everything. These are questions about some of the biggest colleges in the United States. Since you're a little behind, Janine, we're going to let you start the bidding.
Colleges, I can answer four of those.
Jason, she sounds pretty sure of herself, and he says, prove it, Janine. For $300, answer four of these. With over 51,000 students, I'm the biggest college in the nation, and you'd think someone from my campus could find a better name than Golden Gophers.
I don't know.
That would be the University of Minnesota, the Minnesota Golden Gophers. With my tasty nut of a mascot called the Buckeye, I'm the enormous Midwestern University smack dab in the center of Columbus.
Ohio State.
Yes, that's one. You need the final three. I'm the school located in the state where everything's big. Visit my Austin campus, and you'll see a plethora of lengthy Longhorns.
University of Texas?
Yes. Number three. Don't worry, it's dry heat. Attend a kegger at my large Tempe campus, and you'll learn why we're called the Sun Devils.
Arizona.
More specific?
Arizona State?
Yes. Arizona State University. Get this, you get the money. Come visit me in Madison. I'm the big college with the little badger for a mascot.
University of Wisconsin.
Yes, $300 off your debt for that. Okay, that's category one. Category two is worth $400, and it is hair care products. Janine, start the bidding. Hair care products, something you ought to know a lot about.
I can answer four of those.
Jason.
Prove it.
Jason once again says, for the second time, prove it. I'm the name of a gooey product for your hair and the last name of the star of Ed Wood.
Depp.
D-E-P is right. Depp. I'm a substance you put in your hair, a chocolate dessert, and the type of animal Bullwinkle is.
Moose.
Yes. According to my ad, I'm the brand whose hair color is so natural, only your hairdresser knows for sure.
Miss Clairol?
That is correct. Answer this one, and you get the $400 knocked off your debt. I'm the company that puts out Preference, the hair care product preferred by spokesperson Sybil Shepherd.
L'Oreal.
You have the money. Two in a row for you. $400 off your debt. This one will be worth $500, and it is famous TV addresses. These are questions about TV shows and the addresses of their major characters. Janine, start the bidding.
I can answer three of those.
Jason, she said four last time. This time it's three. You want to go for four or call it?
I can answer four.
He says four, Janine.
Prove it.
And she says, you know what? For minus 500. Question one. I'm the modern Stone Age family you could hang with at 345 Stone Cave Road.
Flintstone.
Yes. I'm the ABC sitcom where you might swing by 714 Delaware Street to have a loose meat sandwich with Darlene, Becky, and DJ.
Roseanne.
That's two. I'm the 70s sitcom where 711 East Ocean Parkway in Brooklyn was often entered via the fire escape by Gabe Kaplan's students.
Welcome back, Carter.
That's three. You need one more for the 500. I'm the show where 000 Cemetery Lane was where you'd find the haunting home of Morticia and Gomez.
The Adams family.
You have $500 taken off your debt for that. This is the $750 category, and it is really pale people. This category is about people and things that are pale. Now, this is a must-win situation for you, Janine. If you don't get this category, you'll be mathematically eliminated, and Jason will win the game. All right, start the bidding, Jason.
I can answer four.
Janine? Game's up for grabs on this one.
I can answer five.
Going to go all five. All right, Janine, if you do answer all five, you'll remain alive in the game. The game will continue. Anything short of five, Jason's our winner. One, I'm the female star of the pickup artist whose pale skin could probably be burned by the light of just 16 candles.
Molly Ringwald.
That is one. I'm Bob Hope's film spoof of The Virginian and the words movie Indians often use to describe the white man. The pale face, Jason, is our winner. So congratulations to you, Jason. That means you'll move on to the final round of debt with a chance to have us pay off your entire debt amount. And you, Janine, will go home with this. Julie.
Well, Janine, sorry, we're not going to pay off your bills, but we are going to give you one of our debt piggy banks, along with a $500 savings bond. Sit back and watch it mature.
And it was from a movie called The Pale Face, starring Bob Hope a few years ago, from whence an Academy Award song came along called Buttons and Bows. You remember that too, don't you?
Oh, absolutely.
Sure you do. You're much too young for that. We'll be back to see if this guy right here, Jason, can find financial freedom right after this commercial message.
Bill's got you down while there's help in sight. If you'd like to be a contestant on Debt and you live in the L.A. area, call 213-520-2300. And we're back to see if Jason can get out of debt with the help of our main man, Wayne.
Welcome back to Debt, everybody. Jason, who's in debt because of his wedding expenses, played the first two rounds. He knocked his opponents off handily. $3,400 he knocked off of his debt. Nicely done.
Thank you.
Now, before we continue, see if you can knock some of these questions off. You got into debt because of wedding expenses. Did you have one of those big church weddings?
Well, actually, no. We went to Vegas and got married.
Oh. Well, where did the expenses come in? Don't tell me you went to the tables.
Unfortunately, yes. We stayed around in Vegas just a bit too long.
So that's included in the so-called quote-unquote wedding expenses.
You better believe it.
All right, let's see what you can do about that. You have earned the right to have us pay off your entire original debt of $7,157. As you know, this is the round we call Get Out of Debt. If you can answer 10 of these questions in 60 seconds, your debt of $7,157 will be completely wiped out. Are you ready?
Yes.
Okay, your category is movie lines you don't stand in. In this category, you'll hear the quote, and you'll have to tell me which movie it's from. We set your expiration date at 60 seconds, and your time starts now. I'm the film where Judy Garland says, Toto, I have a feeling we're not in Kansas anymore.
Wizard of Oz.
Yes. I'm the film where Tom Hanks says, Mama always said, stupid is as stupid does.
Forrest Gump.
Yes. I'm the film where Robert Duvall says, I love the smell of napalm in the morning.
Apocalypse Now.
Yeah. I'm the comedy where Chevy Chase says, be the ball.
Caddyshack.
Yes. I'm the film where John Gielgud says to Dudley Moore, I'll alert the media.
Arthur.
Yes. I'm the film where a mountain man says to John Voight, you sure have a pretty mouth.
Deliverance.
Yes, I'm the pick where John Belushi asks, did we give up when the Germans bombed Pearl Harbor?
Animal House.
Yes, I'm the movie where Kristen Scott Thomas says, promise me you'll come back for me.
The English Patient.
That's right. I'm the flick where Marlon Brando says, I'll make him an offer he can't refuse.
The Godfather.
Yes, I'm the pick where Ally McGraw says, love means never having to say you're sorry.
Pass.
I'm the flick where Dustin Hoffman says, Mrs. Robinson, you're trying to seduce
me. The Graduate.
Yes! Give me a big five, bro. Well done. Time to spare. 11 seconds left. Wasn't that nicely done? Not an easy category when you stop and think of it. You know your movies. I'm the pick where Ally McGraw says, love means never having to say you're sorry. Audience? Love Story. Eric Siegel's great story. Well, congratulations, Jason. It gives me a great deal of pleasure to make this statement. Sir, you are officially out of debt.
Yes.
However, it's one decision after another, right? Well, you're married now. You know what I'm talking about. Now, because we're offering you the opportunity to bet your debt right now, we're going to continue. When we selected you to be a player on the show, you told us your specialty category in the world of pop culture was the movie Pulp Fiction. So before the show, we wrote one special question about the movie Pulp Fiction. And if you can answer this question correctly, we'll not only pay off your debt of $7,157, we'll give you that same amount in cash. In other words, we'll double it. And here it is in this briefcase with our debt security guard, Mr. Clean. However, if you go for this money and you miss, you lose everything. And as we always point out, true, it is a big risk. But at the same time, it is a very large payoff if you pull it off. So do you go from $71.57 to double that? We're going to give you a little more time to think about it as we take a final commercial break. Okay? We'll be right back to see what he wants to do.
It's time for another Big Money Moment on Debt.
Welcome back to the moment of decision, as always, here on Debt, and it's a big decision. Jason, you've had some time to think about this money, this question. If you go for this question about the movie Pulp Fiction, you know it will be worth double what you already have, $14,314. So the question is always, what's it going to be? You want to risk it all, go for the big payoff, $14,000 and change, or stop now and walk away with $7,157 and your bills paid off?
Go for it!
Well,
yes.
My wife would kill me if I didn't get this right, and I love being married, so I think I'm going to stay and go.
You're going to stop at this point and be assured of walking away with $7,157. And as pretty as his wife is over there in the wings, I think he is probably correct about what she would do to him if he missed this. Here's the question. After John Travolta and Samuel Jackson finish ditching a body with Harvey Keitel, the duo grab a bite at a coffee shop. While they are there, Tim Roth attempts to rob the place. I'm the name of the eating establishment.
Hawthorne Grill.
That is correct. Well, you didn't go for it, but you're still going home with a debt paid off in the amount of $7,157. I got to congratulate you for that. Congratulations to you. That's all the time we have left, everybody. We'll be back next time with three more big spenders like Jason, and we'll do our best to help get them out of... Wink Martindale, bye-bye, everybody.
Promotional consideration provided by Oneida's gift certificate for your choice from an elegant collection of full-lead, mouth-blown, hand-cut crystal featuring stemware, barware, and giftware furnished by Oneida. This Magnavox mini hi-fi shelf system features a programmable 5-disc CD carousel, surround sound output, digital sound control, dual cassette deck, and stereo digital tuner from Magnavox. Smart, very smart.
Coming up, Intimate Portrait Star Attitude Week begins with Natalie Wood next. And premiering tonight at 9, it's a Lifetime original movie, Indiscretion of an American Wife. Then the premiere of New Attitudes at 11, only on Lifetime.
This is the personalized license plate of a teenage talker. If you can figure out that it says party line, then you're ready to play Bumper Stumpers. And now the driving force on Bumper Stumpers, Al Dubois.
Hello, thank you very much, and welcome to Bumper Stumpers, the show that turns a highway hobby into challenging fun for you. And some ready cash for our contestants and Ken Ryan, who are today's players.
Once again, welcome back our returning champions, sister and brother, Linda and Ron Eisenberg, and their challengers, mother and daughter, Kathy and Diane Grosso.
Hi, everybody. Welcome back.
Thanks, Al.
I want to talk a bit more about what you people do for a living. Obviously, you know what I do for a living. Linda, you are a journalist.
Mm-hmm.
And what are you doing specifically?
I write articles, preferably good ones, for several magazines.
Uh-huh.
Mm-hmm.
Reputable magazines, of course, not,
Smut magazines.
Thank you, Ron.
This is my nice brother here.
Yeah, Ron the lawyer. Hi, Ron.
Hi, Al.
I thought maybe you'd be overqualified for this game show. You know, being a lawyer, I thought maybe that should be,
solving puzzles all day, trying to get clients' money, so now I'm trying to get some money for myself and Linda.
Well, that's a pretty good idea. You have some new friends here on the block just about to take on yet another game here, or continue a game that we left off with yesterday. Kathy and Diane, a mother and daughter team, and a couple of teachers. What level are you teaching, Kathy?
I'm teaching kindergarten children.
Kindergarten? Is that tough? Seems to me that must be grueling. Those
Actually, it is. Harder than a lot of people think.
Uh-huh.
But it's fun.
But I guess you have to enjoy it.
Oh, of course.
And Diane, you're, of course, Kathy's mom, as we mentioned, and you are a university counselor. What does that mean exactly?
I evaluate the teachers as the students as they're teaching, go around to the schools and see them,
uh-huh.
Give them pointers.
Mm-hmm. My teacher.
What to do, what not to do.
Mm-hmm. And how is Kathy doing? You've been very much a part of her before.
Excellent. Well, she has a job.
This is great. Okay, everybody ready to play Bumper Stumpers?
Yes.
Sure. Yes.
All right, let's do it then. On with the show. Starting a brand new match here, and of course the object of the game is to solve the Super Stumper. The first team to solve two Super Stumpers wins the match, $1,000, and then moves on to the bonus round to win 2,000 smackaroonies. All right, when we left off, we had four spaces remaining in the middle of this first game of the match. We're looking for a plate that belongs to a therapist, but of course you can't see one until you win a jump in. So take a look at these two plates and tell me which one, the left or the right, belongs to an ultra-conservative driver. Kathy.
Left.
No, Ron and Linda, 10 seconds, go.
Veer to the right.
Veer to the right is right, yes. All right. Veer, V-R, veer to the right, R-Y-T. You did that very well. Do you sing together at all?
Yes, we do.
Excellent harmony. Okay, over to the Super Stumper, looking for a plate that belongs to a therapist. We have four spaces remaining. Which plate would you like next?
Three, please.
Okay, behind the third one, we have...
I'm out to cure you. I'm on to your pain.
I move you well.
I move your pain. I move your back.
Oh, no. Three spaces remain. Back to a jump in. Take a look at these two plates and tell me which one, the left or the right, belongs to a stripper. Dan.
Cheek.
Quickly, which one? Right?
Left.
Correct. Kathy, 10 seconds, go.
Cheek, cheek, cheek. Cheek, cheek.
Ron and Linda, 10 seconds,
go. Cheesecake.
Cheesecake is right, yes. Stripper, cheese, C-H with the E's, and then cake, break up the two K's, cake, cheese, cake. All right, Ron and Linda, that brings us back to the Super Stumper. We're looking for a plate that belongs to a therapist. We have three spaces remaining. If you win this, of course, you'll win the first game of the match. Which space would you like next?
Seven, please.
Behind the seventh one, we have a two. 5 seconds, go.
I'm
on your two. I'm on you.
Sorry, time is up. Two spaces remain. Back to a jump in. Take a look at these two plates and tell me which one, the left or the right, belongs to a reluctant romantic. Diane.
Right.
Correct. Kathy, 10 seconds, go.
Maybe later?
Maybe later is right, yes. M, long A, may, B, L, 8-er, maybe later for a reluctant romantic. Kathy and Diane, over to the Super Stumper. You're still in here. You have two spaces remaining. Looking for a plate that belongs to a therapist. Which one would you like?
Number four, please.
Behind the fourth one, we have a K. 5 seconds, go.
I'm okay, you're
I'm okay, you're
too.
Okay.
I'm okay, you're okay, too.
Time is up with one space remaining. Back to a jump in. Take a look at these two plates and tell me which one, the left or the right, belongs to an etiquette teacher. Linda.
The right.
Right, Ron, 10 seconds, go.
The entropy.
Kathy and Diane, 10 seconds, go.
Don't point.
Don't point is right, yes. DNT, don't point, the abbreviation for a point. I guess that's what we'd expect from a teacher, right, Kathy?
Okay.
Do you get a lot of pointing in your class?
No, never.
Never. You don't allow it, right?
Of course.
Let's go over to the Super Stumper. One space remains. This is for the first game of the match, Kathy and Diane. Now, let me remind Ron and Linda that if they don't get it, we're going to go right over to you, so you're not out yet. Let's see what is behind that last space. For a therapist, an R. 5 seconds, go.
I'm okay, you are too.
Yes, you got it. I'm a therapist. I'm O-K-U-R-2, breaking down all the last letters there after I'm. Kathy and Diane, congratulations. You won the first game of the match. Now, Ron and Linda, as you know, you're not out until you lose, too, so we'll play another game if it's all right with you.
Sure.
Okay, but what we're going to do first is pause for this commercial break. We'll be right back.
Put a rubber spider in the shower.
This was before we were married.
Whoops! The newlywed game tonight at 7:30 and 11 Eastern.
I know you were really hoping to cash in on that screenplay that you never started, but I'm here to tell you there's a better way to make it in Hollywood.
Hollywood Showdown tonight, 8 Eastern, 5 Pacific on Game Show Network.
Welcome back to Bumper Stumpers. We are in the middle of a match, which Kathy and Diane are winning now, one game to none, and Linda and Ron in a must-win situation. All set for another game?
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Let's do it. This Super Stumper belongs to A 90-year-old, we will give you the first space. It is a 4. The remaining 6 you must earn by winning a jump in. So take a look at these two plates and tell me which one, the left or the right, belongs to a perpetual bridesmaid. Kathy.
The right.
No, Ron and Linda, 10 seconds go. Perpetual
Throw
bridesmaid.
Rice.
Throw rice. Throw rice, yes. T-H-R-O, throw, R with the ice, eyes, throw rice. Ron and Linda, over to the Super Stumper. A plate that belongs to a 90-year-old. You have the first space. Which one would you like next?
The second, please.
Behind the second one, another 4, 5 seconds, go.
4 score 10.
Yes, you did it!
Woo!
Yeah! Fours. If you take the fours and run the S with a K, 4 score and 10. Roman numeral for 10. Very well done. That was a fast one. That brings you right back in to tie up the match. Good stuff, Linda and Ron. All right, Kathy and Diane, as you probably know, you're not out until you lose two. So how about another game?
Okay, sure.
You up for it? Okay, very important one, the rubber game coming up here on Bumper Stumpers. This time, a super stumper that belongs to a hen-pecked husband. A hen-pecked husband. The first space is a 2. The remaining ones you must earn by winning a jump in. So take a look at these two plates and tell me which one, the left or the right, belongs to a police officer. Diane.
Left.
Correct. Kathy, 10 seconds, go.
Under arrest?
Under arrest, yes. Woo. Wow, hot, fast-moving game we have here. Police officer, UNDRREST, under arrest. All right, Kathy and Diane, over to the Super Stumper. 6 spaces remaining. We're looking for a plate that belongs to a hen-pecked husband. Which one would you like?
Number 2, please.
Behind the second one. An N. 5 seconds, go.
Too nice to talk. Turned around.
Yep, 5 seconds is up. Back to a jump in. Take a look at these two plates and tell me which one, the left or the right, belongs to a prayer leader. Linda.
The right.
Correct, Ron. 10 seconds, go. Prayer leader.
Prayer leader.
Kathy and Diane, 10 seconds.
Our father,
yes. R, and then FR, abbreviation for father. Our father, prayer leader. Diane and Kathy, over to the Super Stumper, looking for a plate that belongs to a hen-pecked husband. 5 spaces remain.
4.
Behind the fourth one, a B. 5 seconds, go.
Too nervous.
Time is up in a match that is all tied up here. 4 spaces remain. Back to a jump in. Let's take a look at these two plates and tell me which one, the left or the right, belongs to a down-home cook. Kathy.
The right one.
Correct. Diane, 10 seconds, go.
Beef stew, yes.
You did it. BF, beef, S-T-U, beef stew for a down-home cook. Diane, Kathy, over to the Super Stumper. 4 spaces remain in a very critical game here. We're looking for a plate that belongs to a hen-pecked husband. Which one would you like?
Number 3, please.
Behind the third one, we have a D. 5 seconds, go.
Second boss.
No more time. 3 spaces remain. Another jump in. Take a look at these two plates and tell me which one, the left or the right, belongs to an uptight guy. Linda.
The left.
Correct. Ron, 10 seconds,
Straight
go.
Lace.
Straight lace, yes. S-T-R with the 8, straight, and then L with the A, straight lace, straight lace. Linda and Ron, over to the Super Stumper. And this would be for the game, the match, $1,000 and a chance to move on to the bonus round. We're looking for a plate that belongs to a hen-pecked husband. Which
5.
One of the... You want the fifth one.
Sorry.
Let's take a look. An N, 5 seconds, go.
Second bent.
Sorry, 5 seconds is up. 2 spaces remain. Kathy and Diane, you're still in there too. So back to a jump in. Take a look at these two plates and tell me which one, the left or the right, belongs to a spy. Diane.
Right.
No, Ron and Linda, 10 seconds, go. A spy.
Secret code
with a long O, not cod, secret code. Linda and Ron, 2 spaces remain. We're looking for a plate that belongs to a hen-pecked husband. This is for the game, the match, $1,000 and a chance to win more money. Which one would you like?
The 6th, please.
behind the sixth one. An N, 5 seconds, go.
Second bent.
Second bent, bent. Second bent,
bent.
Plate that belongs to a hen-pecked husband. We still don't have a winner. One space remains, but you have to earn that one. So a very important jump in coming up. Whoever gets this jump in has a good shot at winning the Super Stumper. So take a look at these two plates and tell me which one, the left or the right, belongs to a quarry worker. Diane.
Right.
That's right. 10 seconds. Go, Kathy.
Rock pile. Rock pile.
That's right. Yeah. For a quarry worker. R, small o, k, rock, pie, p-y-l, rock pile. Kathy and Diane, over to the Super Stumper. One space remains. This is for the game, the match, $1,000 and a chance to win more money in the bonus round. But let me remind Ron and Linda that you're not out yet. If they don't get it, we're going to go right over to you, so stand by. Let us take a look at the final space. And A, 5 seconds,
second,
go.
Banana. Second banana.
Second.
That's right. You got it. Yes, a hen-pecked husband, second, S-N-D, second, B-N, B-N, and with N-A at the end, second banana for the old hen-pecked husband. Kathy and Diane, congratulations, you won the game, the match, $1,000, and to win some more money in the bonus round. Linda and Ron, it has been a pleasure having you on our program.
Thank you.
Thank you very much for being here. All the best. And you're going away with $1,000. That's not too bad at all. Okay. Good luck. And we'll be back with a bonus round right after this commercial break.
Ten Eastern.
Welcome back to Bumper Stumpers. Kathy and Diane are just about to play their very first bonus round. Are you ready for this?
We're ready.
You've already run $1,000, a chance to win possibly $2,000 here. What we have is a set of 7 stumpers that will appear one by one on our monitors. For each one you get correct, you increase your chances in this bonus round. But all you have is 30 seconds. So if you get stumped, just yell pass. And if there's time at the end, you can go back and try to solve what you didn't get. Okay, let us begin with a plate that belongs to a fugitive.
Escape artist. Escape artist. Escape artist. Escape.
Pass.
Pass.
Kitty car.
Timely. Timely.
Pass.
Pass.
A 90-year-old Romeo.
Fun and...
Need 10 for 80.
Pass.
Pass.
Peacekeeper.
Fun and mender. Fun and... No minder.
Sorry, your time is up. You didn't get any correct. Oh, that's
this is a first.
That is a first. You should be proud of yourself. This is the first time this has ever happened. Let's have a round for Kathy and Diane. First time that no one has won anything. Let's take a look at the ones you have revealed. Fugitive, escape, escapist, rather. Escape, C-A-P-A-S-T, escapist. Kitty car, tell me why. Tell me why. A 90-year-old Romeo, anyone over 80, N-E-1-0-4-80. Peacekeeper, a fence mender, fens, two N's, M-N, mender, D-R, fence mender. Oh, well, that's too bad. So at least now you know how it works.
We do.
You've just gained some experience, and maybe next time you'll do better. How about another game and another match?
Certainly.
Sounds like a good idea. Okay, Ken Ryan, how about some new challengers?
Welcome to Computer Whiz and the Starving Writer. Say hello to Craig Peckham and Lance Stewart.
Hello, Craig.
Hi.
Hello, Lance. Well, this is an interesting game, this Bumper Stumpers. Anything can happen. How are you?
Fine, thank you.
Welcome to the show. Craig, what do you do for a living?
I'm a salesman of computer interface cables to dealers across the country.
And you're pretty busy these days, but I guess you have enough leisure time to come down here and play some Bumper Stumpers with
us. You're very right.
And you've known Lance for a while?
About 11 years.
Yeah. Lance, how did you two come about meeting for this occasion?
Well, actually, Craig called me up. I was about the 14th person he called to get in the show. And I said yes, and he said, I'll pick you up in an hour, and I went, great.
Okay, good stuff. Well, I hope you can win some money.
Great,
all set
you.
To play?
Mm-hmm. Yes, we are.
Let's do that then. Okay, Kathy and Diane, I know you're ready to win some more money, so let's do it. The object of the game is to solve the Super Stumper. The first team to solve 2 Super Stumpers wins the match, $1,000, and a chance to move on to the bonus round to win more money. At least we hope so. Kathy and Diane hope so, but they have a chance next time around for sure. Okay, we're going to begin this time with a plate that belongs to a gas guzzler. We'll give you the first letter, which is a D. The remaining six you must earn by winning a jump in. So take a look at these two plates and tell me which one, the left or the right, belongs to an Indian landlord. Diane.
Right.
Correct. Kathy, 10 seconds, go.
TP for rent. TP for rent. TP for rent. TP for rent. TP P for rent. TP top.
Indian landlord, Craig and Lance, 10 seconds.
TP's for rent.
TP's for rent.
TP's for rent, yes. T, two P's, P's, four, rent, R-N-T. Kathy almost had it. There was that S that you were missing for Indian landlord, TP's for rent. Craig and Lance, 0 for 2, the Super Stumper. Looking for a plate that belongs to a gas guzzler. You have the D. Which space would you like next?
Number two, please, Al.
Behind the second one, an E. 5 seconds, go.
Drive.
Diva gas. Oh.
Deficit in your gas.
Sorry, your 5 seconds is up. Let's have another jump in. Take a look at these two plates and tell me which one, the left or the right, belongs to an exorcist. Lance.
The left, please.
Correct. Craig, 10 seconds, go. Exorcist.
No months. Node months.
Exorcist.
And no demons.
No demons, yes. No D, M-O-N-Z, no demons, exorcist. Craig and Lance, back to the Super Stumper, looking for a plate that belongs to a gas guzzler. You have a D, you have an E, but you also have 5 spaces there. Which one would you like next?
Number 6, please.
Behind the 6th one, we have a J. 5 seconds, go.
D.
D.
D, help us.
D, job.
Sorry, your time is up. Can't see another space until you win a jump in, so take a look at these two plates and tell me which one, the left or the right, belongs to a juggler. Kathy?
The right?
Correct. Diane, 10 seconds, go.
Dexterity.
A juggler, Craig and Lance, 10 seconds.
Dexterity.
Dexterity, yes. D-X, dex, T-E-R, tear, T, dexterity for the old juggler. Certainly an asset. What do we have? We have 4 spaces remaining at the Super Stumper. We're looking for a plate that belongs to a gas guzzler. We're in the first game of the match here. Lance and Craig, which one would you like next?
Number 3, please.
Behind the 3rd one, an E. 5 seconds, go.
These cars.
Ooh, time is up. 3 spaces remain. Take a look at these two plates and tell me which one, the left or the right, belongs to a messenger. Kathy?
The right?
No. Craig and Lance, 10 seconds, go.
Mercury.
Mercury.
Yes, Mercury. M-R, Mer, Cure, Q, Cure-E, Mercury. A bit of a tough one. Messenger, Lance and Craig, that brings us back to the Super Stumper. 3 spaces remain. This is for the first game of the match. We're looking for a plate that belongs to a gas guzzler. What do you think?
Number 4, please, Al.
Behind the 4th one. An L. 5 seconds, go.
Diesel truck, diesel jar, diesel junk.
Time is up. 2 spaces remain. Okay, you're not going to get one until you win a jump in. We're really making you work for this. Take a look at these two plates and tell me which one, the left or the right, belongs to a penmanship teacher. Lance.
That's the left one?
Correct. Craig, 10 seconds, go.
Dot your eyes.
Yes, beautiful. Dot your eyes. A small O, dot. You are your... eyes. Craig and Lance, 2 spaces remain. This is your chance to win the game. First game of the match. Which one would you like?
Number 5.
Looking for a plate that belongs to a gas guzzler. Behind the 5th one, we have an N. 5 seconds, go.
Diesel engine.
Time is up. 1 space remains. Diane and Kathy, you're still in there. All right, everybody. Let's just... Craig, you're too hard on yourself. Yeah. Hurt yourself, we're going to have to give you a hard hat. Listen, we'll be back right after this commercial break.
Family Feud asks, what were they thinking?
A department in a supermarket.
Lingerie.
Family Feud, Richard, relatives, and the occasional ridiculous remark. Tonight at 8:30 and 12:30...
Welcome back to Bumper Stumpers. In this match with Craig and Lance and Kathy and Dan, we don't have a winner yet, but we're getting pretty close. Over at the Super Stumper, we have 1 space remaining. And of course, you're not going to see it until you win a jump in. So this is a jump in that is very important for everybody. So take it slow and easy and take a look at these two plates and tell me which one, the left or the right, belongs to an anxious bachelor. Kathy.
The left.
No, Craig and Lance, 10 seconds, go.
Be my mate.
Be my mate, yes. Be my, M with the eight, be my mate. Okay, Craig and Lance, this is for the first game of the match. We have one space remaining. Kathy and Diane, if they don't get this, we're going to go right over to you. So stand by, you never know. All right, we're looking for a plate that belongs to a gas guzzler. Behind the last space we have an N.
Diesel engine.
Diesel engine.
That's right, diesel engine. You did it. Yes, diesel engine. D with the E's, D-E-S-L-N-J-N, diesel engine. All right, congratulations, Craig Lance. You won the first game of the match. Kathy and Diane, of course, you're not out until you lose two. So we'll continue next time. Time to go now. Take care, everybody. See you again.
Bumper Stumpers is a global television production in association with Bailey and Enright Productions and Wink Martindale Enterprises, produced in cooperation with the USA Network. Guest accommodations provided by the Ramada Hotel Don Valley. Let us introduce you to Ramada style, Ramada comfort, and our very affordable Ramada prices. Next time, Ramada Hotel Don Valley.
Show Network. All play, all day.
You are about to be witness to an examination. Several of you have decided to try your skills against the participants. But be you player or spectator, be prepared. For you have just been invited to an Inquisition.
Michael Hackamack of San Francisco. Steve Saunders of Fullerton, California. Roy Etnier of Evanston, Illinois. And Jeff Parkin of Seattle. You are here to prove yourselves versus your fellow man. There can be but two outcomes, success or failure. In one, you shall find refuge. In the other, pain. Neither shall come swiftly. Now, shall we begin? The 1973 Vietnam Peace Accords were signed in A, Paris, B, The Hague, C, none of the above. Mr. Etnier, you alone have the acumen to give the correct answer. A. Paris. Jabberwocky is a nonsense poem by A. Lewis Carroll. B. Emily Dickinson. C. None of the above. A. Lewis Carroll. At Stanford, Chelsea Clinton is A. Pre-law. B. Pre-med. C. None of the above. B. Pre-med. I wonder where she'll be interning. Drove my Chevy to the levee is a line from A, born in the USA, B, little deuce coupe, C, none of the above. C, drove my Chevy to the levee is a line from American Pie. The Coty Awards honor those in A, fashion, B, education, C, none of the above. A, fashion. Zero gravity exists, A, underwater, B, on the moon, C, none of the above. C, zero gravity exists in outer space, Mr. Saunders. Brothers Liam and Noel Gallagher are core members of A, Culture Club, B, Oasis, C, none of the above. B, Oasis. Geologically, the oldest Hawaiian island is A, Oahu, B, Kauai, C, none of the above. B, Kauai. John Glenn returned to space on A, the shuttle Discovery, B, the shuttle Endeavour, C, none of the above. Mr. Parkin, A, the shuttle Discovery. A conundrum is A, a mystery, B, a play on words, C, none of the above. A, a mystery. Hurricane Mitch devastated A, Cuba, B, Nicaragua, C, none of the above. B, Nicaragua, Mr. Saunders. Lou Grant was played by A, Carol O'Connor, B, Gavin McLeod, C, none of the above. C, Lou Grant was played by Ed Asner. The Blue Devils are from A, Villanova, B, Duke, C, none of the above. The answer, B, Duke. The Tailhook Association was comprised of A, Navy Flyers, B, Air Force Flyers, C, none of the above. A, Navy Flyers. The more precise and correct answer would be oversexed Navy Flyers. In Rear Window, Jimmy Stewart is A, in a wheelchair, B, mute, C, none of the above. A, in a wheelchair, Mr. Hackamack. The Reign of Terror is associated with A, the Russian Revolution, B, the French Revolution, C, none of the above. B, the French Revolution. Mr. Saunders, if you don't pick up your pace, you will have a personal experience with a reign of terror. Billy Joel was married to A, Cheryl Teagues, B, Cindy Crawford, C, none of the above. C, Billy Joel was married to Christy Brinkley. On a sunscreen label, the F in SPF stands for A, formula, B, factor, C, none of the above. Mr. Saunders, the answer is B, factor. Among Robin Hood's merry men, Alan a Dale was A, a minstrel, B, an archer, C, none of the above. A minstrel. The Bismarck was sunk during A, World War I, B, World War II, C, none of the above. Equal ineptitude. B, World War II. Panettone is A, a rice marshmallow treat, B, a fried bread, C, none of the above. C, panettone is a fruitcake. That concludes this portion of the exam. Mr. Saunders, please leave now.
Frequent.
Game Show Network. Have you played today?
Well, Mr. Hackamack, Mr. Etnire, Mr. Parkin, find no security in your present position. Your past success is just that, past. Let us continue. A group of gorillas is called A, a band, B, a pack, C, none of the above. A, a band, Mr. Etnayer. The church lady is A, Martin Short, B, Dana Carvey, C, none of the above. B, Dana Carvey. At a funeral, you might hear A diatribe, B, a dirge, C, none of the above. B, a dirge, which is a funeral hymn. And if you listen carefully, you can hear one in the distance. Maurice Ravel was A Canadian prime minister, B, a French composer, C, none of the above. B, a French composer. The Phantom of the Opera lives A, in the opera house, B, beneath the opera house, C, none of the above. B, beneath the opera house. President Clinton likes to summer vacation A, on Martha's Vineyard, B, in Malibu, C, none of the above. Oh, Mr. Heckamack. A, on Martha's Vineyard. The bikini was named after A, Bikini Island, B, Francoise Bikini, C, none of the above. A, Bikini Island. Ralph Emerson's middle name was A, Wadsworth, B, Waldo, C, none of the above. B, Waldo. Simone de Beauvoir was A, a French novelist, B, an American industrialist, C, none of the above. A, a French novelist, Mr. Hackamack. The Aztecs once ruled A, Peru, B, Mexico, C, none of the above. B, Mexico, Mr. Parkin. After President Reagan was shot, the person who insisted, I am in control here, was A, Oliver North, B, Alexander Haig, C, none of the above. B, Alexander Haig. I believe it was Nancy who corrected him. Howard Stern's right-hand woman is A, Robin Quivers, B, Stephanie Miller, C, none of the above. A, Robin Quivers, with whom you all seem to be acquainted. If people admire your acumen, it's because A, you have a great body, B, you have a soft heart, C, none of the above. C, if people admire your acumen, it's because you have keen insight. Pablo Escobar was the leader of A drug cartel, B, a guerrilla group, C, none of the above. A drug cartel. The Crystal Cathedral is the setting for a weekly TV show featuring A, Oral Roberts, B, Robert Shuler, C, none of the above. B, Robert Shuler. Pop Warner was A jazz saxophonist, B, a college football coach, C, none of the above. The answer, B, a college football coach, Mr. Parkin. A disease existing from birth is called A, genetic, B, congenital, C, none of the above. B, congenital, Mr. Hackamack. While the race is quite close, you, Mr. Hackamack, are not close enough. And you know what happens to laggards, don't you? Yes?
Yes, Master.
I presume you'll do better.
Yes, Master.
The movie The Sunshine Boys starred George Burns and A, Walter Matthau, B, Art Carney, C, none of the above. A. Walter Matthau, Mr. Parkin. The United States' highest military award is A. The Medal of Honor. B. The Congressional Commendation. C. None of the above. A. The Medal of Honor. Mr. Parkin, an actuary calculates A. Risks, B. Projected costs, C. None of the above. A. Risks. I'm told your risks are too high to be calculated. You can see Helen Thomas at A. Carnegie Hall, B. The Ice Capades, C. None of the above. C. You can see Helen Thomas at a presidential press conference. A one-star general is A. A brigadier general. B. A lieutenant general. C. None of the above. A brigadier general. Look out, Mr. Hackamack. That concludes part two of the exam. Goodbye, Mr. Hackamack. Mr. Etnaya, Mr. Parkin, while you presently stand together soon enough, one of you will not stand at all. I advise you be relentless in your pursuit of victory. There's no second place in this event. Let the games continue. The Princess Bride was written by A. The Brothers Grimm, B. William Goldman, C. None of the above. B. William Goldman. The host of Firing Line was A. Howard K. Smith, B. William F. Buckley, C. None of the above. B. William F. Buckley. Dancin' in the Streets was a hit record for A. Martha and the Vandellas, B. The Ronettes, C. None of the above. A. Martha and the Vandellas. Wilt Chamberlain's first NBA team was A. The New York Knicks, B. The Philadelphia Warriors, C. None of the above. B. The Philadelphia Warriors. You would most likely have a Napoleon as A. An appetizer, B. An entree, C. None of the above. C. You would most likely have a Napoleon as a dessert. Logan Airport is in A. Chicago, B. Boston, C. None of the above. B. Boston. The TV drama The Practice is about A. Doctors, B. Lawyers, C. None of the above. B. Lawyers. Milli Vanilli was accused of A. Extortion, B. Plagiarism, C. None of the above. C. Milli Vanilli was accused of lip syncing. I was once accused of the same thing. Of course, the accuser is no longer with us. A sign reading abierto means a store is A, open, B, closed, C, none of the above. A, open. The phrase cry over spilt milk is A, an axiom, B, an idiom, C, none of the above. B, an idiom. Tivoli Gardens is located in A, Italy, B, France, C, none of the above. C, Tivoli Gardens is located in Denmark. When Doves Cry was a hit for A, Madonna, B, Prince, C, none of the above. B, Prince. Ernie Kovacs was A, a band leader, B, a comedian, C, none of the above. The answer, B, a comedian. The Old Bailey in London is A, a courthouse, B, a theater, C, none of the above. A, a courthouse. Cartoonist Chick Young created A, Blondie, B, Mama, C, none of the above. A, Blondie. In Schindler's List, Schindler was A, a German entrepreneur, B, a German commandant, C, none of the above. A, a German entrepreneur. Louis J. Free is A, our UN ambassador, B, Secretary of the Treasury, C, none of the above. C, Louis J. Free is FBI director. Trickle-down economics is associated with A, the Carter administration, B, the Reagan administration, C, none of the above. B, the Reagan administration. Unfortunately, the trickle turned out to be a bit fickle. The People's Temple cult was led by A, Jim Jones, B, Marshall Applewhite, C, none of the above. A, Jim Jones. The journalist who worked as a Playboy bunny for a story was A, Diane Sawyer, B, Gloria Steinem, C, none of the above. B, Gloria Steinem. The word latent means A, tardy, B, potential, C, none of the above. B, potential. Cheerios are made by A, Quaker, B, Kellogg's, C, none of the above. C, Cheerios are made by General Mills. The music at the beginning of a musical is A, the cantata, B, the overture, C, none of the above. B, the overture. Red Adair gained fame as A, a football player, B, a country singer, C, none of the above. C, Red Adair gained fame as a firefighter. Time has expired, and so have you, Mr. Parkin. Goodbye. Mr. Etnaier, you have faced your challengers and dispatched them without hesitation. For this, I salute you and grant you back your papers.
Thank you, Inquisitor.
Take them and return from whence you came. That concludes tonight's Inquisition.
Congratulations to today's winners, who have each won $250.
Thank you very much. We're having great fun this week. Unfortunately, we're not going to be with you tomorrow on Friday because you're all going to be enjoying, along with us, the tennis U.S. Open. But even though this is an abbreviated week, I hope we get these people back because we have two favorite fantastic stars playing the game. They play the game well, and one of them is too close for comfort, and his name is Jim J. Bullock, and he's right there.
Thank you.
You can always tell a genuine star because genuine stars wear yellow shirts.
Is that true?
Oh, yes, it's true. Most people don't know that. But
I had no idea.
I know that you didn't know. That's why I'm here to tell you these things, Jim. I do serve a function, you know. I don't just get in the way all the time.
Other than sleeping.
Other than sleeping, yes. And especially when you wear a yellow shirt with a red star, that really sets you off
nicely.
Does
it really?
Uh-huh.
Thank you. You're really beautiful.
Now, aside
from...
Let's
have sushi together, okay?
Oh, please, we must. Have your people get in touch with my people. On Too Close for Comfort. What else is keeping you busy these days? Any movies coming up? Anything? Everybody after you or what?
Well, I just finished. No, no one's after me.
Okay, then we'll talk to Amy. Amy?
No, go ahead and talk to them, really, Tom. It'll be more interesting.
Nobody wants you, huh?
No, really.
Well, we'll come up with something for you before this day is over.
Okay.
Believe me, we will.
I know you will.
Ladies and gentlemen, our champ, Amy Webb Robbie, with $11,300. Amy Webb's originally from Oklahoma and now living on the West Coast.
Right. And I'd like to say that yesterday was my grandmother Phillips's birthday. Happy birthday, Grandma.
Yeah, I'm glad you got that.
She's
forgot
in
all
Oklahoma.
About it. I knew it was your grandmother's birthday, but I forgot all about it. But anyway, you got that in. As I said, stars wear yellow shirts, right? Yep. Ladies and gentlemen, Lynn Swine.
Tom.
Yes?
I know you're usually perfect. So I guess I shouldn't question the fact that you said stars wear yellow shirts and red stars.
Oh, yellow shirts, period. Forget about the red star. Green stars are even better. Green stars, green on yellow is...
It's not easy being green.
That's right. Now, when I said star, you think he's not only the star of the gridiron, he is also the star of the dance floor, having danced with the likes of Gene Kelly, Peter Martins, and Twyla Tharp. And that's true.
Thank you.
Yes, indeed. You danced with Gene Kelly and Peter Martins on Omnibus.
On Omnibus, and Twyla Tharp choreographed what she called a wide receiver ballet.
Did she really? I didn't know about that.
Yes, she did.
Just for you.
Just for myself and Peter, and we had big fun.
You have studied dance seriously.
14 years, ballet, tap, and jazz.
How nice.
Well, listen, you had to do things when you're a small guy playing.
I know you've been asked this a million times, but I have to know, how did you get from dance to the gridiron? How did that happen?
Well, usually I left the gridiron to go dance.
Oh, I see.
And that's how I got real fast. Because when you leave football practice early with a pair of tights and ballet shoes, and your name is Lynn. Great, that's an arrow. If I ever get married and have kids, George,
yeah.
Jack, Johnny, you know, Bill, strong names.
Hadn't thought of that, yes. No wonder he's so fleet-footed. All right. The other half of the green team, Becky Castaneda, is back. And Becky has $100. And Becky is going to school where?
At Fullerton Junior College.
Fullerton Junior High. No.
College.
Junior College.
Minors.
The kids were all summer long. These are the big people.
Yes,
now.
That's right. Sorry about that. Junior college.
Okay.
Okay, Becky.
I'll let you pass.
Object of our game, act out a series of words to help your partner solve a puzzle. Now, what else does do you need to know? That's about it, huh? Amy, get over there and good luck to you. Jim, come with me. Did you get any of it on the walls?
You know, last time I was on this show, I wore something similar to this.
Yeah, but that's right, you did.
It was a complete outfit, though.
I know this had to be different because you don't wear outfits twice, do you?
No. I burn them when I get home.
That's what I thought.
Yeah, we all do.
60 seconds on the clock.
All right.
Here's your first word, and go.
You're eating something. It's an apple. It's fruit. It's...
Pass.
Okay, it's a little square thing. It's luggage. It's briefcase. It's a suitcase. It's a case. It's a woman. A purse. A bum. Watch. A basket. A basket lady. A basket lady. He's a whole street people. Basket
pass.
People.
Pass.
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 Okay. All right. What do we have here? You're taking off pants. They're very tight. They stink. They're dirty. Laundry. Dirty laundry.
Yes, you got it. Now.
You're eating something from a fruit. It's fruit. You're planting its seed. It's a magic fruit. It's a shriveled fruit. It's a raisin. It's a prune. It's a plum.
Pass.
You're distressed. You don't know what to do. You're very confused. Can I help you?
Oh. I tell you, it's remarkable. There was a lot of good stuff that went on there. Really. There was some good stuff, but you guys were on different frequencies. It was like,
yes.
You know?
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
But it'll all come together, I'm sure.
We're hoping.
Yes, that's right. Here's your problem. Here's your one word. Let's see what we can make of it. Blank makes these blank blank that are the size of blank and have more blank than the dirty laundry of a blank? Now go.
Germs.
Is it germs? All right, Becky. Becky, which blank next?
Number 7.
All right. Blank makes these blank that are the size of blank and have more blank than the dirty laundry of a bag lady. Amy.
2.
Blank makes these dried blank that are the size of blank, etc.
Stains?
Is it stains? Becky.
1.
Sunsweet makes these dry. What is it?
Raisins?
Is it raisins? No. Back to Amy.
Hey, star 4.
All right. Sunsweet makes these dried blank that are the size of walnuts, etc.
Prunes.
Prunes, she says. Prunes it is. Well, he showed you fruit that had dropped to the ground, right. And he withered right before
right.
He dried up and withered. That was for dried, right?
Oh.
Right? All right. Yeah, what?
Oh.
Yeah. Sunsweet makes these dried plums.
Plums. Oh, that's everything but plums. I said everything but plums.
And you actually said plums at one point, I think. No, you said prunes. One of those. I don't know. But you said it when he was on another word. That are the size of walnuts and have more wrinkles than the dirty laundry. Dirty laundry, you got, that's right, and bag lady. Okay, so that takes care of that. Anything to say?
Oh, no, just give me some more plums today, Tom. Those are real easy.
$100, the first team to reach $500 wins our game and a chance of $10,000. Back with Lynn Swanstein right after this. $100 for the red team, and the green team says, let's go. Becky, get over there.
The victory.
Yes, the victory.
Come on, man.
Becky has to win. We have to put her through college.
Hey, do me a favor. Show me a basic dance step.
A basic?
Yeah.
I mean,
I know you've got on your dance
shoes. I've got my tennis shoes on. I can't do the ballet stuff very well.
You can't?
You can't hear that, but those are wings.
That's a wing?
Maybe we'll just call it a soft shoe.
Oh, yeah. I was thinking more in terms of ballet. Hey, you better tie that shoelace before you get going, because I don't want you to fall down and go boom. That's a football term. All right.
Boom?
Yeah. 60 seconds on the clock. And here is your first word. And go.
You're a soldier, salute. Scolding. General, major, sergeant, lieutenant, chief.
Pat!
Golly gee, you're bashful, shy, clumsy. You're confused. You don't know what you're doing.
Pass.
You're walking. You're a farmer. Hillbilly.
Yeah, you got it. Thanks.
Pass.
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 Pass. Pass. Pass. Pass.
All right,
pass. Pass. Oh,
geez. Pass that.
Okay.
All right, he wants that.
You're cutting something. Sign. Cut. You're an animal. You're a gorilla. Monkey. 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 You're wiping. Monkey.
Okay, good try. Good try. Ooh. You got one of them.
Oh!
It's painful, I know. They started with one, now you start with one. Here's your puzzle, here's your one word. $100 puzzle. This actor, blank, a blank, hillbilly, who was a blank, and then joined the blank and made his blank blank.
Buddy Ebsen?
Is it Buddy Ebsen? By golly, it could have been. All right, Amy, come over here. You're a good puzzler, a puzzle solver, Becky. Amy, which blank would you like next?
Number 5.
All right. This actor, blank, a blank hillbilly, who was a blank, and then joined the Marines and made his blank blank.
Jim Nabors.
Oh, is it Jim Nabors? By golly. Yeah. You, too, are a good puzzle solver.
That was great.
Woo! Yes. And this actor, what, played, Lynn passed on that one, a goofy. He was goofy. He was acting goofy out there.
That was a good goofy.
Yeah, it was.
Wasn't goofy enough.
Well, your goofy was a lot like a hillbilly, but you got hillbilly, all right. This actor played a goofy hillbilly who was a grease monkey.
Oh.
See, He established monkey, and then he was showing you grease under the car.
Oh, yeah.
And then joined the Marines and made his drill sergeant.
Oh.
You had sergeant at one point. You're trying to get the drill. And made his drill sergeant nuts. You golly. $200 for the red team. We'll be back with our $250 puzzles after this. $200 for the red team, zero for the green team. Now we go into $250 puzzles, and if neither team reaches $500, we'll then have a playoff. And in our $250 puzzles, if all five words are guessed, the contestant will receive what I have in my little pocket here, a $500 check signed by Mr. Goodson.
Oh,
and,
yeah. Is it real?
Uh-huh. It's real.
And
it's
blank.
Oh, no,
yeah. Isn't that a
pen? Let's earn it, folks. Jim over there, Amy down here. Okay, you guys are all set.
Oh, we're set.
Okay, 60 seconds on the clock. Here's your first word. Go.
Driving. Backing up.
You got one.
Star. Television. Big screen. Popcorn. Movie. The big boom,
pass.
The big bang. Teeth. False teeth.
You should pass.
Pass.
Dog. Animal, cow. Shot. You get a shot? Branded. Brand. Iron rod. Iron raft. Iron, what the hell are they called?
Oh, pass it!
Pass.
Branding iron. Hot.
Yes, that's right.
Pass.
Pass on that. And
no.
Didn't have a chance to get back. Okay, too bad. Time caught up with you there, but you got two of them. You got two. Here's the puzzle. Here are your two words. $250 puzzle. A guy with a blank likes hot blank ones, and if you back up into a blank, yours will be as blank as blank. What do you think?
Brand?
Is it brand? No. Mr. Swan. Which blank next?
Number five.
A guy with a blank likes hot blank ones, and if you back up into a branding iron, yours will be as blank as blank.
Iron?
Is it iron? Jim?
One.
A guy with a sweet tooth likes hot blank ones, etc. What do you think? Time, Lynn.
Number six.
And if you back up into a branding iron, yours will be as scorched as blank.
Buns?
Is it buns?
Buns?
You thought it was a throwaway, right?
It was a throwaway.
I don't believe it.
Buns?
Why, sure, because a guy with a sweet tooth likes hot cross ones. Hot cross buns, you see?
That's the way I feel about it.
Isn't that hilarious?
That's fabulous, Tom. I love this game.
I know. A guy with a sweet tooth, see, sweet tooth, she was saying, tooth, and then she said sweet. Okay, likes hot cross ones, and if you back up into a branding iron, and you said branding iron when it was too late, after she had passed, she was trying to get back to it when time ran out.
Damn it.
That's the word she was trying to think of. Yours will be as scorched as The Towering Inferno was the movie that she was taking you to.
Oh.
Uh-huh.
Okay.
And so that
rolling,
means...
Rolling, rolling, rolling. Keep them cattle rolling.
You stay here. You sit down, Jim. Come on over, Becky.
You fired up.
Another 250. If you get all five, there's a $500 bonus waiting for you.
We got it.
60 seconds on the clock. Here's your first word. And go.
Stethoscope, doctor, nurse,
pass.
Surgeon,
pass.
Slap, hit, man, a slap man, slap happy, slap, man, punch man, punching bag, dummy, punching, hit him, hit, man. Hitman.
Yes. That's it. Next.
Your
you're making notes. You're a nurse. You're making notes. You're a secretary.
Pass.
Sky? Up. Man of the moon. Priest. God. Angel. God. Stop. Man. The baby. You. With the baby. God.
Dive. Okay. You got one.
Hard.
Yes, I know. Come on. Get your buns up here. Come on. You can't leave now. Here's your puzzle. Here is your one word. You should blank the blank before you blank one, and if the blank puts one blank on you, you'll soon blank a hitman. Answer?
Godfather.
Is it Godfather? Jim, come over here. Which blank next, Jim?
One.
You should examine the blank before you blank one, and if the blank puts one blank on you, you'll soon blank a hitman. Lynn?
Number four.
You should examine the blank before you blank one, and if the Godfather puts one blank on you, you'll soon blank a hitman.
Fish?
Is it fish? Jim?
Fish?
No, no. Jim.
You should... Two. Right.
You should examine the fine print before you blank one. What is it?
Contract.
Is it contract? You should examine the fine print before you sign one. If the Godfather puts that one out on you, you'll soon meet a hitman. Can you see him? Say, put a fish out on that guy.
Fish! Hey, that's the same thing. It means you're going to hitman.
That's
coming
right.
Up to the dump near the ocean.
Hey, go to your chairs. Go to your chairs. Get over there. Amy, Becky, come over here. Come over here. Amy, don't pay any attention to him. Go to your chair, young man. I'm going to put a fish out on him. Here's your, we have to have a playoff. Here's your puzzle. This is the blank blank, where you blank in blank blank. Amy, you want to go first or Becky?
I'll let Becky go.
All right, Becky?
Five.
This is the blank blank, where you gamble in blank blank.
Casino.
Amy.
Number one.
This is the state, blank, the blank blank, where you gamble in blank blank.
Nevada.
Becky.
Two.
This is the state near the blank blank where you gamble in blank blank.
Arizona.
Amy?
Three.
This is the state near the big blank where you gamble in blank blank.
North Dakota.
Becky?
Four.
This is the state near the big apple where you blank in blank blank.
Pennsylvania?
Amy?
Oh, number six.
This is the state near the big apple where you gamble in Atlantic blank.
New Jersey.
That's it. In Atlantic City, and it wins the game for the red team. And we have to say goodbye to Becky with $350, and Amy will have a chance of $10,000 after this.
Love to play? Then log on to GameShowNetwork.com. From classic game shows to the latest innovations, GameShowNetwork.com puts the world of play at your fingertips. GameShowNetwork.com. Why just surf when you can play?
Amy has elected to receive every word worth $100. 60 seconds on the clock. Here's your first word, and go.
You are walking a tightrope. You're walking a bridge. You're balancing. You are a tightrope walker. You're
Pass.
The cork. Champagne. The popping the cork.
Pop is at 100.
You're sitting on a bench, on a chair. The chair, the bench, the seat.
200.
You're shoveling. It's the
Read it. Look. Carefully.
Oh, pass.
Okay. All right, pass.
All right, you're sucking your thumb. You're a little baby. You're a little one. You're a little baby. And you are the parent. You're a kidnapper.
$300.
Thank you. Go.
Yes, pass. Okay.
You're looking. You're searching. It's foggy. You're lost.
You have 400.
You're thinking. You're nervous. They're late. You're late. You're nervous. You're worried.
500.
You're stirring. Oh, it's hot. What's that? You burned your finger.
Okay. That was for scorch.
Oh.
But you got five of them. For 500, which can become 5,000, you got the next three words in 20 seconds. 20 seconds on the clock. Here's your first of three words, and go.
You're stirring. You're mixing.
One down, two to go.
You're carrying something. It's a cane. It's a crutch.
Two down, one to go for $5,000.
It's a house. It's a big building. You're crawling under it, in the basement, in the roof, in the attic. You're in the attic. You're nailing. You're building. You're building the shingles. Shingles. You're hiding. You're building. I don't know what you're doing.
Oh, Amy. He was He was pitching a tent. It was a tent. We'll be right back. You still have $500. Join us.
Nobody told me which pile do I take it from.
First one.
Best of Family Feud.
This one here like this?
Weeknights at 8 p.m. And
next week, Phyllis Diller and Richard Simmons. Thanks, guys, for a great week. See you then. Bye-bye.
Some of our dependent possessors will receive zero in on the action with these 35-millimeter binoculars. Includes high-powered insta-focus with bright, sharp image. No-nonsense pantyhose with 16-point contouring to make you look and feel terrific. Whatever your fashion, no-nonsense fits, and that's no-nonsense. The Mr. Coffee Altronic System, space-age technology for the most perfect cup of coffee on this planet or any other. Control, discover the secret of losing weight with Control. Control capsules give your willpower the help it needs so you can eat less and lose weight. Use as directed. And a member of our studio audience will receive his and hers Wimbledon tennis racket. Dynamically weighted for more power, greater head speed, and better control, made from a special blend of boron and graphite from Time Sport. This is Gene Woods speaking for Body Language, a Mark Goodson television production. This program was edited for broadcast.
Welcome to the quick draw game that everyone can play. It's win, lose, or draw. Come on in and join our host, Bert Convy. With Bert's guest, the lady that won an Emmy for her starring role on Golden Girls, everybody's sweetheart, Betty White. And from the hit television series Designing Women, the enchanting Annie Potts. The star of the Dom DeLuise Show, actor, director, bon vivant, Dom DeLuise. And ladies and gentlemen, for five consecutive years, the number one male motion picture box office draw in the world, Burt Reynolds. Okay, take it away, Burt.
I thank you very much. Thank you. Welcome to Win, Lose, or Draw, ladies and gentlemen. It's nice to have you with us, and thank you for tuning us in. This is a game that we have played for years. It feels like we've played it for many years, but actually just a short while on television. But it all started at Burt Reynolds' house, and that's why our set looks this way, because it's modeled after Burt's house, right, Burt?
It sure is.
Yes.
Yeah.
I have all these people here, usually, in
right,
the house.
Right. Usually have a big party.
Do you have anybody in the vacuum, Burt?
No, we will have someone to clean in. She comes in twice a week. We've met our celebrities. We always play men against the women. I think you've got all that stuff. It's time to meet our contestants. Shall we do that? First of all, joining Betty and Annie is a college student originally from Livonia, Michigan. Is that right? Say hello, please, to Kelly James. Or is it James? James? Nice to meet you, Kelly. Thanks for coming. We met Betty. Joining Bert and Dom is a clothing store manager and a weekend cocktail waiter, it says. Say hello to Jason Saris. Jason, nice to meet you. Welcome to you both. The object of our game is to convey famous names, places, things, titles, whatever, to your teammates. And the problem with that is you can only do it by drawing. That's why we have the pad up there. And you're a very good drawer, Dom.
Oh, well, because I was born. You know, some people are born with a silver spoon in their mouth.
Yes.
I was born with a crayon in my mouth.
Is that right?
Yeah, we were poor.
Yes.
But I took the crayon and drew.
Yeah.
And drew.
You drew very well.
Oh, yes.
As a matter
I made
of fact.
That up, too.
Yes, it was very good.
I'm sorry, I went into it.
No, it was very good. Okay, you can't use letters or numbers. However, you may write down the correct word, if you think that your team has it and they're a little unclear. You can put the word on the board. That's kind of a little change in our rules. The team with the most money at the end, of course, wins, and then we add a bonus of $1,000. And before the game, we tossed a coin. Guess who won? The women did, and we'll start with Betty White.
All right. Yay!
You said we had to draw. You didn't say we had to write. I didn't know about that.
You don't have to write.
Is it true this is Burt Reynolds' pad?
This is Burt Reynolds' pad, yes. Okay.
Go for it,
this is going to be a famous person. It's going to be worth $200 to your team, and you have 1 minute to get it, but after 30 seconds, you're going to hear this sound effect. When you hear that, you can pass off to one of your teammates. If you do, the value of the name goes down to $100. Let's show everybody at home who this person is. And if you're all set, you'd probably like to see it too, Betty.
Be fun.
Okay, I'm going to show it to you then.
Okay.
Okay. Ready and go.
Okay, it's a king. It's King Edward. Is it King Henry? It's King Lear. It's King. It's King Richard. King.
What's he doing? King. King Cole.
Nat King Cole.
Yes.
That's it. You got it. $100 for the women. Very nicely done. No problem. Okay, that's $200 for the women, I should say. Next up for the men, Burt Reynolds. Come on, Burt. Here we go. Watch yourself. All right, you ready? You all set?
Okay.
Huh? You all set?
Yeah.
Okay, you have 1 minute to do this, all right? Okay. So everybody at home, who this famous person is. You guys can come in if you'd like to get a little closer. You all set?
All three of you.
Here we go. Okay. Ready and go.
It's a tree. It's a guitar. Elvis Presley. It's a mandolin.
Glenn Campbell. Violinist. A violinist. The man is a violinist.
Violinist. It's Arthur Fiedler.
Zubin Mehta. Smiling, big smiling face.
Smiling violinist.
Smiling, a happy violinist.
A fiddler.
Jack Benny.
That's right. I don't know how you did that, but you did. Okay, not too bad. They did very well. We have a tie score. The men have $200. Women have $200. We will be back with more win, lose, or draw after this message for you. Wait a second. I don't know how you got here.
Don't delay. Call now.
Some of these words are received by players across the country, and we're going to mention their names. As a matter of fact, this could be anything. It could be anything at all. A place, a thing, a person, whatever it is, okay? The value of each question is still worth $200. That stays the same. And if you hand off, it goes down to $100. Now, we'll start this time with Annie Potts. Come on, Annie.
Come on, girl.
All right. Would you like to see what this is?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Oops. There it is. Got it?
I didn't see it.
Okay. You didn't see it? Well, I'm so sorry. Show everybody at home what it is. If you're all set, let's go. Ready and go. You have a minute.
Okay. It's ears. It's ears. It's a person. It's a stumbo. It's ears
and that's
it's a toilet.
Ear flush. Ear drum.
Is that a sound alike? Because you can do it.
No, it's not.
I'm terribly sorry.
Ear John.
It's
Dear John. No. Ears bowl. Ears toilet.
Boomer. Ears outhouse.
Ears seat.
30 seconds. Want to hand it off?
Yes,
all right. Next to Betty.
What is it? Oh, for heaven's sake. Oh, dear.
That's worth $100.
Ears, face, ears, nose. Oh, ears, person.
Oh, that's good. That's good.
What is ears, hands, ears, clock? Ears, 12. Oh, no.
All right, too bad. Hang on a second now. Now, fellas, you can steal this for $100. I think I see what you're trying to do. I knew up there what you're trying to do. Guys, we get one guess from me. What do you think for $100?
Is there a John in the word?
Yes. I think you said it.
What?
Dom, what did you say?
John.
Ears, John? You're very close.
Here's Johnny.
Yeah, but it's too late. It's too late. Here's Johnny. Here's John.
Okay.
We received that from Kenneth Ross in Lamberton, Mississippi. Thank you, Kenneth.
So good.
I have everybody autograph it for you. Come on, Dom, you're next up. That doesn't change the score.
I'm showing that picture. It was more like Poindexter.
Yeah, that's right. All right, well, the score's tied. You each have $200, so there's a lot of pressure here if you're all set, okay?
You know how you wet your pen sometimes?
Don't do that.
I thought, ooh, no.
Ooh, okay, so everybody at home what the word is. We have a tie score.
Oi.
Okay. All right, here we go. Ready and go.
Arrow, point.
House.
Over the house.
Over the house.
Steps. Over house. Lightning.
Is that a scream?
Saw. T.
That's not a...
Save.
Pig.
That's a pig. Oh, yes.
Pig.
Pig.
Okay.
Pig.
All right.
In the stream. Pig stream.
Pig stream. River pig.
River. Pig in the stream. In the trough.
Over
in
the house.
House.
Barn. It's a barn.
30 seconds.
Barn. Pig house. House pig.
House.
Pig house.
House.
Forget
no
the pig.
No pig.
Kill the pig. What you the pig?
The house that killed the pig.
Pig. Bacon. And tomato house. Hot bacon.
Hot house.
Over bacon. Hot house bacon. A pancake house that. Bacon and
egg.
Bacon.
House.
Home cooked bacon.
No, okay, now don't say any more. Don't worry, Dom. You can't say any more.
Well, they got it now.
No, they haven't.
Sure they do.
Look at their faces. They don't have it. All right, ladies, you can see what it is. You can steal this. You can steal $200, as a matter of fact. The score is tied at the moment. What do you think it is, ladies? They don't go away. What's your explain it?
Home question.
What do you think? Ladies, I need your guess.
Home fries, no.
Home fries.
I got it, Bert.
Now
bring home the bacon.
That's it. Bring home the bacon. You want to explain it, Dom? Tell
me. This is spring. This is home. This is killing the pig. This is the bacon. This is the sizzle.
Perfect.
Here's a fork to eat it.
Where is
Perfect.
Bring with the...
This is bring. This is bring.
That is not bring.
And this is marjoram bread.
That one goes to Michael and Brenda Rogers from Ravinia, Ohio. Thank you for that. All right, Kelly, it's your turn. Come on up here. All right, now, we still have a tie score, by the way, 200 to 300. All right, you all set? All right, you ready to go? Let's show everybody at home what this one is. This is a good one. Here you are. I love when they go,
it's
oh,
a cinch,
no.
Kelly. Don't
all
worry
right,
about
Kelly,
it.
You can do it. You have a minute. Let's go. You ready? And go.
It's a flower.
Champagne,
it's a champagne glass.
Glass.
Cocktail glass. Glass.
Wine.
Crystal.
Wine.
Wine.
Days of Wine and Roses.
Yes.
Oh! I can't believe that.
Oh!
Can't do any better than that. Okay, that goes, I don't know who that goes to. It doesn't matter. It doesn't go to anybody. We made that up ourselves, in fact. All right, come on, Jason. You're tied one now. Here
okay,
we go.
Come on, Jason.
All right, the score is 400 for the women, 200 for the men. Show everybody at home what you just did.
Oh,
that
that'd
one.
Be easier.
That's easy. There you go. All right, everybody at home got it? Ready and go.
Oh, really? A cricket? No. Cricket? No.
And
it's a bug, though, right?
An insect.
Legs.
Fly legs.
Insect legs. Spider legs.
Spider legs.
Legs.
Long legs. Legs.
Daddy long legs.
That's it. Very nice. Nice going. We have a tie, which is only fitting at this point. We'll come back in just a moment with a speed round and break the tie. You both have $400. We'll see you in a second. Don't go away.
I've never seen any.
Nine. Order now.
Hey, did they ask you a question? Who invented blue jeans?
You guessed Sergio Valente? No, it was Levi Strauss.
Did you try yelling big bucks, no whammies?
Did you just curse me?
Watch out, it's back. Whammy, the all-new Press Your Luck. Weeknights at 10 p.m. only on Game Show Network.
Yes, come on, it's really just a game show.
Really, ask me a question.
Mrs. Brady, Mrs. Partridge, Mrs. Whammy? It's the mother of all game shows on Saturday, May 11th. See your favorite moms on great game shows, plus a very special Mother's Day edition of Whammy, the all-new Press Your Luck, featuring Dharma's mom, Laura Ingalls' mom, and George Costanza's mom.
And this is what I say to the Whammy.
That's the mother of all game shows, Saturday, May 11th, from 9 p.m. to 12 midnight Eastern and Pacific. Oh, mama!
This is our speed round, and we have a tie game. Makes it very interesting. The women have $400, and so do the men. Each question this time is worth $100, each word or whatever it is. And we'll start with the team that's ahead, okay? Oh, by the way, you can pass twice.
There is no team that's ahead. It's
there
tied.
Is no team that's ahead, so we have to start with the women. I think it's only fair, don't you? Come on, Betty White. Oh, no, it's
no,
Annie Potts
who's
going to draw. Okay, here we go. Okay.
Okay,
now you go as fast as you can.
Good
you can
luck.
You can pass twice, and I'll just throw that word out, okay?
Okay.
Show everybody at home the first word.
How many words are there?
There'll be as many as you
as
can
many,
get.
Okay.
Yeah, I have a big stack here, see?
All
so
right,
you can just
all
keep
right.
on going.
Okay.
You all set? Okay, here you go. Ready and go.
It's an animal. It's a smile. It's a face. It's teeth. It's singing.
It's a
voice.
Spoon.
It's
a little mouth.
It's
lips.
It's
teeth.
Smiling.
It's a jacket, shirt, jacket,
it's
coat.
An animal.
It's a coat.
It's a clothing.
It's a coat. It's a.
It's pocket. It's in a
it's
pocket.
A jack. A
pocket.
Jack.
Mouth. Lip.
All right, that was a pickpocket. Okay, here you go. One pass left.
Okay, it's a nose, it's a face,
it's profile,
it's someone singing, it's talking, it's lips.
You have a
it's
minute
a
left.
Smoking cigarette.
Okay, there's another one. That's $100.
Oh, pass on that
pass
one.
Pass on that. That was lightheaded. Okay, here you go. Next one. Women have $500.
All right, it's a face.
It's
no passes
a
head,
it's a tear.
It's a tear.
A tear, crying,
this
crying.
45 seconds.
What is this?
Lighter.
It's crying, it's a, oh no.
It's a
stove. It's hot.
It's hot burners.
It's burners. Burning tears.
Crying.
Oh, tears.
Hot.
Burning eyes.
Oh, it's good stuff. 30
eyes.
Seconds left.
Hot stove.
Oh, I can't pass.
You can't pass. No.
Tears.
You'll just have to get it.
Well, I certainly will. Tear.
Tears.
Burner.
Tears.
Tear. Burner.
Tears.
Turn on.
Turn on
the tears.
Don't give up. Come on, Annie.
Come on. There's no time left.
Yes, there is. There's 10 seconds left.
Oh, God. I can't do anymore. I can't do anything that's not nasty.
Crying over spilt milk.
Tear gas. Tears.
I thought it was an electric stove, for heaven's sake.
Okay. Thank you, Eddie. The ladies have $500. You mean you only got one? You got
rub
more than
it
one?
In, Bert. Go ahead.
All right, I'm sorry about that. It seemed like you're up here a long time.
Going to get
one. All right, who's drawing for the men? Bert, come on up here.
We get more than one.
That's your head?
That's right.
All right, you only need two to win. You get two and it's all over.
Yes.
All right, and we add $1,000 bonus to whomever wins, okay?
Take a deep
if you're all set,
breath.
Let's show everybody at home. No, you got a minute and a half, and then here we go. Ready?
No.
Okay, here we go. Go.
Heart, ears,
face,
Clark Gable,
man, spit, saliva,
tears again.
No.
It's a freckles, stars, freckles,
pimples, dirt,
zits.
What's coming off his face?
That's what I'm asking you.
Make beard, stop. Beard. Stop beard. Stop.
Stop. 5 o'clock shadow.
Dust. Tears, sweat.
That's right. All right, there's one. One more to win.
What?
There it is. One more to win. Got a minute left.
A straight thing, an arrow.
Corner.
Angle. Right angle. Corner.
Corner's it. Men win. That's it. You got it. Congratulations. Jason has won. We'll come back in just a moment and split up the money. Sorry, ladies. No, you did well.
Second time.
I usually draw the big heads and the little bodies, but one of them already had a big head and a little body.
I ask you a question?
Yeah, who won the 1998 Daytona 500? I said Bobby Labonte.
Wrong. Came in second.
And they threw that pizza dough in your face?
Yeah, but they sat for a portrait.
That's the Whammy, all right.
It's back. Whammy, the all-new Press Your Lock weeknights at 10 p.m. only on Game Show Network.
Turn to the left.
You talking to me? You talking to me? Because I'm the only one here? Do I get the part? You talking to me?
Whammy, weeknights at 10 p.m. only on Game Show Network.
All right, thank you. We're back. Kelly, you won $500 today, so you will take that home. And our thanks for being with us. Truly, we'd like to thank Jason because he's the big winner. The men won $600. We had $1,000. Jason will take home $1,600. Thank you, Jason.
Thank you.
Also, we'd like to thank Annie and Betty for being with us, and Dom, of course, and Bert, too, for being with us. What are you doing back here?
Well, you don't pay that much on the show, so I'm selling these for $1.75.
That's very nice.
Stacy, this is for you. It says
how generous.
It's a dollar. Did I spell it wrong? All right. Well, do you like it? It's $1.75.
Yes. Two more.
Thank you. I'll take fudge instead.
Go and talk to
Dom.
You got fudge? Okay, that's great.
Hey, Dom, you were telling me before that you have you wrote a book.
Yes, I wrote a cookbook.
A cookbook? Well,
yeah.
What's the title?
It's called Eat This. It's coming out in...
Thank God, I thought you were mad at me.
No. It is coming out for Christmas.
It is.
It's really a good book. It's a lot of Italian recipes and stories about growing up in New York. In fact, Burt Reynolds has a recipe in my book. It's a fantastic recipe, a beef stew, which is so delicious. And you know, on the bottom it says serves.
Yes.
His serves one man and four girls. You had to be there.
Yeah, no, you didn't. It's
good.
This
is really nice, and I enjoyed... Can we just finish off? Are we going to say...
Yeah, well, I think we haven't got too much time. We do have some time, actually. I wanted to thank everybody for being here, especially our studio audience, who I think enjoyed themselves. Do you think you could draw better than our people up here? I think I probably could, but I'm not so sure. But on the other hand, sometimes you don't know if you feel like you're right. But sometimes I get very sad, and other times I reach in my pocket and I scratch myself. But on the other hand, sometimes it's a little damp, you know. I don't. We'll see you next time, I hope, if we're not a garage right here on Win, Lose, or Draw. Goodbye, everybody. Thank you.
My roommate.
My congressman.
Who do you want to see fall down a hole? Russian Roulette coming June 3rd only on Game Show Network. Coming up next, learn to speak the universal language of laughter, body language. Then head up the $25,000 pyramid, followed by Password. Game Show Network, a winner every 30 minutes, guaranteed.
Win, lose, or draw is a Burt and Burt production in association with Klein and Friends.
Four strangers, one goal. To win a head-to-head competition for the chance at $100,000. One wrong answer could be their last. This is Russian Roulette. From Walla Walla, Washington, box office attendant Sean Egan. From Cleveland, Ohio, dog walker Amy Altschuld. From Hollywood, California, substitute teacher Paige Klein. From Salt Lake City, Utah, event coordinator Cherise Johnson. And now, here's our host, Mark L. Wahlberg.
Thank you. Hey, welcome to Russian Roulette. All four players ready to go. Welcome to all four of you. As you know, a correct answer wins you money and keeps you in the game, but an incorrect answer means you give up all your winnings and you have to pull that little handle you see in front of there and play Russian Roulette. Okay? In this round, we start with one drop zone, and we increase your danger by adding a new drop zone with each new question. These questions are worth $150. We have given you all that amount to start the game. Sean, our lone male player, you've been randomly selected as our challenger. Are you all ready to play the game?
Yes.
Let's play the game. Okay, here's your first question, guys. What physicist first proved that if your body is in motion when it falls through the hole, it will tend to stay in motion? Who do you want to challenge, Sean?
I think I'm going to challenge Amy.
Okay, Amy. Was the physicist Galileo, Isaac Newton, or Johann Kepler? Four seconds.
Galileo.
Is it Galileo? It is not. That theory was posed by Isaac Newton. Incorrect answer right off the bat. There's one drop zone. You lose your money, and you play Russian Roulette, Amy.
Lucky me.
Lucky you. Well, you better hope it's lucky you. Let's play Russian Roulette. Okay, give it a pull. You're now the challenger. We had a second drop zone. There are two drop zones. Here's the next question. In George Orwell's bleak novel Animal Farm, the government is controlled by what mammals? Amy, who do you want to challenge?
I would like to challenge Cherise.
All right, Cherise. Is the government controlled by horses, rats, or pigs?
Horses.
Is it horses? It is not horses, it's pigs. Cherise, you lose your money, and now you play Russian Roulette. There are two drop zones. Unlock Charisse's zones. Really okay, open. Anything you'd like to say before you pull that handle?
No!
Let's play Russian roulette. All right, Charisse, pull the handle. Challenger, Charisse.
Okay.
There are now three drop zones. You're the challenger. Here's the next question. Beyoncé Knowles is one of the founding members of what popular all-female singing group? Charisse, you challenge one of these three players. Who do you want it to be?
I want to challenge Paige because she looks like the girl who tried to steal my high school boyfriend.
Oh.
So,
I have never stolen anyone's boyfriend in my life.
Yeah.
Just FYI.
Yeah.
Okay.
Is she a founding member of TLC, En Vogue, or Destiny's Child?
I'm going to say Destiny's Child.
Is it Destiny's Child? It is Destiny's Child. Correct answer. Paige, you have $300. You're now the challenger. There are four drop zones. And here's the next question. In the 1990s, basketball great Michael Jordan led the Chicago Bulls to how many NBA championships? Who do you want to challenge, Paige?
I'm going to go for Charisse. Take my boyfriend. Take none of my money. I'm ready.
Is the number of championships 4, 5, or 6?
The number is 6.
Is it 6? It is. Okay, Charisse, now you are back in control. Guess what? You have some money.
Yay! Hey, I got money.
There are now 5 drop zones. You're the challenger.
All right.
Here's the question. At the time of her murder, starlet Dorothy Stratton was the girlfriend of what Hollywood director? Charisse, who do you want to challenge?
I would like to challenge Sean.
Sean, was Dorothy the girlfriend of Peter Bogdanovich, Ross Hunter, or Roman Polanski?
Hmm.
4 seconds.
Roman Polanski.
Is it Roman Polanski? It is not. Your money goes to Charisse. The correct answer was Peter Bogdanovich. And now, my friend, there are 5 drop zones. And you have to play Russian roulette. Okay, let's unlock Sean's zone.
Oh,
anything you'd like
great.
To say before you pull the handle?
This sucks.
Well said, Sean. Let's play Russian roulette.
Thank you.
Give it a pull, Sean. Very impressive. You beat 5 drop zones, Sean. That takes a whole bunch of luck. But that sound means time is up. You have no money, Sean. Amy, $150. Paige, you have $300. Charisse, you're in the lead with $450. You are the only one safe from dropping right now. Let's go. All right, Charisse, one of the three players behind you is going to drop. Now, obviously, whoever drops, their money gets split evenly amongst the remaining players. So that aside, which one of these three would you like to see drop?
Well, obviously, Paige.
No!
Yeah.
You really liked that guy, didn't you?
Yeah.
She was a terrible, terrible, dirty bird, wasn't
I'm
she?
I'm very happily married now, so I'm over it, but
right.
At the same time.
We all can all sense how over it you are, Charisse, so let's play Russian roulette. Okay, pull the handle. Let's step back here and see what happens. Remain. Stay tuned to see who falls victim to the drop zone next. Stay with us.
This portion of Russian Roulette.
Welcome back to Russian Roulette. We are back, but Amy is not. 3 players remain. Sean, you have $50. Paige, $350. Charisse, $500. You're in the lead. That makes you the challenger. This round is a little bit tougher, though. The questions are worth $200, but there are now 4 possible answers instead of three. We start with one drop zone. We add a new drop zone with each new question. Charisse, you're in the lead. You're the challenger. Are you all ready?
Yes.
Yes.
Let's play the game. And here is your first question. Before it was renamed by the British in 1664, what was the name of New York City? Charisse, who do you want to challenge? Sean, he has 50, or Paige with 350?
Paige, I'd like to challenge you. You've got a lot of money, and I could use it.
Paige, was it called New Rotterdam, New London, New Amsterdam, or New Portsmouth?
New Rotterdam.
Is it New Rotterdam? No, it is New Amsterdam. Your money goes to Charisse, and you play Russian Roulette, Paige. Unlock Paige's zone. One drop zone to avoid. Let's play Russian Roulette. No, you did.
Yeah, okay.
You're now the challenger, but you have no money. Adding a second drop zone, we now have two. And here comes the question. In the movie A League of Their Own, what Oscar-winning actor plays Coach Jimmy Dugan? Who do you want to challenge?
I think I'll challenge Charisse, because you're doing so well by me.
That's right.
Charisse, is the actor Tom Hanks, Tommy Lee Jones, Nicolas Cage, or Richard Dreyfuss?
It's my very favorite movie, so I know exactly that it is Tom Hanks.
It's like a commercial for the movie right there. Is it Tom Hanks? It is Tom Hanks. All right, Charisse, 1,050, you're back in the driver's seat. You're the challenger, three drop zones. Next question. According to the Christopher Marlowe play, whose face launched 1,000 ships? Who do you want to challenge, Charisse?
I would like to challenge Sean this time. Paige deserves a break.
All right, Sean. Was it the face of Helen of Troy, Cleopatra, Aphrodite, or Cassandra?
Well, I was a theater major, so I hope I get this right. I think it's Helen of Troy.
Is it Helen of Troy? It is. Okay, Sean, you pick up a little bit of money, and now you're the challenger. Four drop zones now. It's getting interesting. Here's the question. In 1939, Thanksgiving was celebrated a week earlier on the third Thursday in November. For what reason? What do you think, Sean? Who do you want to challenge?
Well, since Charisse has all the money, I think I'm going to challenge her.
Okay, Charisse. Was the reason a national turkey shortage, to increase the Christmas shopping season, avert an airline strike, or accommodate the Macy's parade?
I love shopping. I'm going to just absolutely say that it was increasing the Christmas shopping season.
Is it to increase the Christmas shopping season? Unstoppable.
Thank you.
You have 1250. Hey, that sound means time is up. Sean has 250. Paige has no money. And Charisse, you are still the only one safe, and you get to pull the handle. Come on.
All right.
Okay. If Sean goes, we split his money between you and Paige. If Paige goes, there's nothing to split. Let's unlock Paige and Sean's zones. Let's play Russian Roulette. Let's step back here and see who's going. This should be an interesting round when they battle it out for a chance at $100,000 right after this.
You feel tired all the time.
Welcome back to Russian Roulette. We started with four contestants, but now we're down to only two, and it's interesting the two we have. Paige has $125. Charisse, you have $1,375. You will be the challenger. Paige and Charisse, your strategy is everything in this round. You know this, right? Charisse, as the challenger, you could pass the question, as we've done, to Paige and challenge her. Or, if you'd like, you can risk all that you have and you can keep the question, try to answer it yourself, okay? These questions are worth $300 each. We start, as we always do, with one drop zone. Are you ready, ladies?
Yes.
Let's play the game. Okay. Here's the first question. What African-American political figure began adopting the black Muslim faith while serving a prison term? Charisse, you're the challenger. Do you want to answer this yourself, risk all that you have, but keep control, or challenge Paige?
I'll go ahead and challenge Paige.
Paige was the political figure. Louis Farrakhan, Malcolm X, Al Sharpton, or Jesse Jackson?
I believe that the answer is Malcolm X.
Is it Malcolm X? Yes, it is. There are now two drop zones. Here's the next question. For the low price of just $15 million, the U.S. made the Louisiana Purchase from what country? Want to answer this, Paige? Keep control or challenge Charisse?
I think I'm going to challenge Charisse.
Was the country Great Britain, France, Spain, or Canada?
It was Canada.
Was it Canada? It was not Canada.
Ooh, sorry.
No, the correct answer was France. You just lost all your money. Did you say sorry to her?
I did. I'm feeling bad.
All right. Now, there are two drop zones, Charisse. To stay in this game, you have to survive. Unlock Charisse's zone. Let's play Russian roulette. Give it a pull, Charisse. Here's the situation. You have the money, you have control. There are three drop zones. How I Learned to Stop Worrying and Love the Bomb is the subtitle of what 1960s film classic? Charisse, what do you want to do?
I would like Paige to answer that question.
Paige, is it the subtitle of The Wild Bunch, The Manchurian Candidate, Dr. Strangelove, or The Great Escape?
The answer is Dr. Strangelove, and that's my favorite movie, so. Oh.
What are the chances? Is it Dr. Strangelove? It is. Control goes back to Paige. You have $2,100. Four drop zones. Next question. What international bestseller was published in 1966 by sex researchers Masters and Johnson? What do you want to do, Paige?
I think I will pass the question.
You've been challenged, Charisse. Was the bestseller titled The Joy of Sex, Human Sexual Response, Sex and Reason, or The Height Report?
The answer is The Joy of Sex.
Is it? It is not The Joy of Sex. The answer is Human Sexual Response. Okay, you had no money to lose, but now you play Russian roulette with four drop zones. Unlock Charisse's zone. Anything you would like to say?
I'm so scared of this thing.
Let's play Russian roulette. Go ahead.
No! No!
Oh, you survived. But while you were screaming, that sound means time is up, Charisse. Oh. You survived, but there's no time to win it back because your worst nightmare is about to happen. Charisse, it's time to go. Paige, congratulations. You're our champion. Well done. $2,100 is yours. You waited till the end. You took her down.
Yeah.
And now you are the champion. When we come back, Paige is going to try her hand at our five questions. If she answers them correctly, it's $10,000. If she gambles, possibly $100,000 right after this. Yeah.
What's red and wears glasses full of holes and totally original? It's Game Show Network's late night lineup. At 10, it's Whammy, the all-new Press Your Luck. Then at 10:30, Friend or Foe. And at 11, drop in for a game of Russian roulette. Three originals, five nights a week, starting at 10 p.m. on Game Show.
Russian roulette, Paige, you waited it out and you've already won $2,100. It is your money to keep no matter what happens. Congratulations.
Thank you.
That's right.
Thank you.
Now, five questions. You answer them correctly in 60 seconds. You take home an additional $10,000. And at that point, you can take a chance, give up that $10,000, gamble it on one final game of Russian roulette. If you survive, it's $100,000. All right, Paige, let's get down to business. The drop zone opens every 10 seconds. If time runs out or you give an incorrect answer, you're gone.
Yeah.
You know that.
Mm-hmm.
Even if you don't answer all five, we give you $500 for every correct answer you do come up with. All right? You ready, Paige?
I'm ready.
Okay, let's unlock all six drop zones. The 60-second clock starts as soon as I begin reading. Remember, you can pass if you don't know the answer. If time permits, we'll come back to it. Also, I need the phrase, my answer is, for each answer. Deep breath. Let's get you some money, Paige. Good luck. Let's begin. Lawyer, doctor, or detective, what is the occupation of the title character on the TV show Ally McBeal?
My answer is lawyer.
Correct. What is the last digit in the year in which the stock market first crashed, leading to the Great Depression?
My answer is 9.
That's correct. True or false, the official United States flag has exactly the same number of red stripes as white stripes?
My answer is false.
That's correct. Rearrange all the letters in the phrase dream spin to spell the name of a title of a movie based on a comic book hero.
My answer is Spider-Man.
Correct. How many times does the letter N appear in the official name of the 4th of July holiday?
N-D-E-N-D-E-N-C-U. 3 times. My answer is 3 times.
That is correct. Stop the clock. You've done it, Paige. $10,000. Well done.
Thank you.
Wow. You said 3 times and the clock was ticking, and then you said my answer is 3 times. I'm so glad you did that. You got all 5 of them. That's $10,000, Paige.
Yes.
There were 7 seconds left, which means that 5 drop zones have opened. Now, Paige, you've got a lot of money. You've got $10,000 plus the 21 is $12,100.
Yeah.
$2,100 is yours, but if you'd like, we can say goodbye to that $10,000. Pull the handle one last time. If you find that one, the safe zone, that is, you walk out of here with $100,000, Paige.
I'm going to risk it. I'm going to play.
Bold move. All right, so he's going for it. Let's close and reset all of the drop zones. Let's unlock Paige's zone. You've got a 1-in-6 chance of walking out of here with $100,000.
Yeah.
If it comes up red, you drop and the $10,000 goes with you.
Yes.
All right, Paige, good luck. For $100,000, let's play Russian roulette. Good luck. Somebody who goes for it, huh? She went for it. She was bold. The audience, half of them were saying, don't go. Half of them were saying, go. But that half, well, they're a little touched. But anyway, she gambled. She did not win. In the long run, she did win. $2,100 is hers, and that is hers to keep no matter what. That's how we play the game here at Russian Roulette. It takes a little bit of luck, doesn't it? We'll see you next time. And until then, remember, watch your step.
Whammy, weeknights at 10 p.m. only on Game Show Network.
The game with big bucks and whammies is back, bigger and better than ever. It's time to play Whammy, the all-new Press Your Luck. And now, please welcome our host, Tom Newton.
Welcome once again to Whammy, the all-new Press Your Luck. This is where you can spin your way to big bucks and some great prizes, too. And right now, I'd like to introduce you to today's player.
Hi, I'm Renee. I lost 95 pounds, and I need money for a new wardrobe.
Hi, I'm Daniel. I just
just moved here from Cleveland, Ohio, and I am ready to win some big bucks. Yeah.
Woo. Hi, my name is Brenda. I live in Chalice Lake with my dog and my husband, not in that order, and I have a house to fill.
All right, players, I think big bucks are in the air today, but of course the question is, are you ready to press your luck? You ready for that? Okay. Well, we're going to get things going by giving each of you $1,000 to start things off with. You can add to that by taking a chance on the big game board. There it is right behind me there, loaded down with thousands of dollars in cash and prizes, including this gem car. Now, if you want to drive away in that gem car, here's what you need to do. You need to land on the gem space here in round one. You need to land on the car space in round three. Then you need to win the game, and the car is all yours. Good? Good. All right, each time you spin, you can add to your total by landing on a square on the big board up there that contains either a cash value or a nice price. I'll show you how that works now. Ready? Stop! There you go, a juice machine. That would be worth $150 to you. But I want to warn you about the dreaded whammy. You land on that whammy, he's going to come out here, take all your cash, all your prizes, knock you out for the rest of this first round. Now, in this first round, your strategy is you can take as many spins as you dare to take without hitting the whammy, or you can choose to freeze if you're afraid of the whammy or if you think you've already earned enough to win the round, okay? The player that's in the lead at the end of this first round has the big advantage in our final round. And, of course, the player that's in the lead at the end of the game is our winner and the only one that gets to keep all the cash and all their prizes. Good deal? All right. We did a drawing backstage to determine who would go first here. Renee, that's you. You've got $1,000 to start. Are you ready for your first spin?
I'm ready.
Let's put the board in motion for you. Good luck.
I'm feeling lucky. No whammies. Stop.
Stop it. A satellite dish and receiver worth $249 for you, Renee.
Hey.
Down to Daniel. $1,000 to start. Here comes your spin.
All right. I'm ready for that gem card. Bring it up. Here we go. No whammy, no whammy, no whammy. And stop.
Stop it. Move one space to $470 or an MP3 watch. Which
go
would you
for the
like,
MP3
Daniel?
Watch.
You've got Woo! The MP3 watch. That is worth $200 for you. Puts you at $1,200. And Brenda, $1,000 for you. Let's see what you can add to that now. Good luck.
Okay, jump card. No whammy, no whammy.
Stop it. A radar detector worth $349. Brenda, putting you in first place now. Now that we've made it down the line once successfully, we're going to put more whammies up on the board to make things even more entertaining for you. And we come back to you, Renee, currently in second place with $1,249. Would you like to freeze or press your luck?
Well, I'm pressing my luck.
Okay.
Okay. Oh, tango lessons. That sounds fun. Okay. Whoa. Whoa. Stop.
Oh. Whammy. Okay, good to see you laughing, Renee. That makes us a little more comfortable. Unfortunately, the cute little whammy with the pigtails there knocked you out for this first round. The game certainly isn't over for you, but now it's just between Daniel and Brenda. Daniel currently in second place with $1,200. Freeze or press your luck?
I gotta pass Brenda. We're going.
All right.
Press your luck. Here we go. All right, here we go. No whammy, no whammy. Jim Card, where are you? Here we go, and stop.
Stop at $740.
Woo! Yeah.
$1,940 for Daniel. Down to Brenda with $1,349. What would you like to do?
Play.
Press your luck. All right, here we go.
No whammies, no whammies. Jump card. Stop.
Stop at a Borders car. That is worth $400 for you at Borders. $1,749. Daniel, Brenda, watch out. Here come more whammies up there on the big board. Before your very eyes. Renee, of course, out of this first round. Daniel, back to you with $1,940. Freeze and take that into the third and final round or press your luck?
I am going to press that luck. Here we go. All right. All right. No whammy, no whammy. Give me that entertainment center and stop.
Stop. And a gift card to Spencer's Gifts. That is the Spencer's Gifts Executive Collection Kit for you, Daniel. Worth $250. Brings you up to $2,190. And brings us down to Brenda now. Still in second place. Would you like to freeze or press your luck?
I'm pressing my luck.
All right.
Okay.
This is one of my favorite dishes, and it doesn't cost any money. It's a good thing.
All right, Brenda takes it right out of the first round. Your first whammy of the game, down to zero. Daniel, before you make up your mind here, if you want to freeze or press your luck, keep in mind more whammies are coming to the board now. You have $2,190. Still a ton of great prizes up there, some big bucks too. The gem card is still up for grabs there. What would you like to do? Freeze and take $2,190 into the final round with the advantage of going last? Or do you want to freeze right here?
Or Pressure Luck, I'm sorry.
But I'm gonna freeze. You're gonna freeze?
Okay. All right, Daniel, you are frozen. $2,190. Well, at the end of round one, Renee has a whammy, $0. Brenda has a whammy, $0. Daniel, you'll have the advantage in the final round. $2,190. And when we come back, the question round. It happens right after this.
Watch out, it's back. Whammy, the all-new Press Your Luck, weeknights at 10 p.m. only on Game Show Network.
Welcome back to Whammy, the all-new Press Your Luck. Players, we're going to get back to the game here by giving you a chance to earn some spins for the final round of the game now. Of course, the more spins you pick up here, the better chance you have on winning the game. This is how the question round works. I'm going to ask a question. The first player to buzz in will answer that question. Their answer then becomes one of three choices for the remaining two players. Remember that a correct buzz-in answer will get you three spins. You will get one spin for a correct multiple-choice answer, okay? All right, here comes your first question. Good luck. Players, tell me what company produces such computer products as PowerPoint, Outlook, Excel, Daniel?
Microsoft.
And Word. Is it Microsoft, Lotus, or Adobe? Renee?
Microsoft.
Brenda?
Microsoft.
Sure, it is Microsoft, yes. Computer literate folks, we've probably bumped into each other in a chat room or two somewhere along the line. Renee, you get a spin there, you're a one. Daniel, three spins for you on that one. And Brenda, you get a spin as well. Leads us to our next question. According to the title of one of his popular songs, Willie Nelson once advised, mamas don't let your babies grow up. Daniel?
Cowboys?
To be what? Is it cowboys, cheaters, or lawyers?
Cowboys. Renee.
Sure.
Cowboys. Robert.
Cowboys? Okay. It is indeed cowboys. But oh, wouldn't the lawyer song be funny there? Brenda, another spin for you there puts you at two. Daniel, you get three more for that. You're now at six. And Brenda, another spin for you at two. All right, here comes your next question. Oil, publishing, or shipping? Tycoon William Randolph Hearst originally made his fortune in what industry? Brenda.
Publishing.
Publishing, oil, or shipping? Renee?
Publishing.
Daniel?
I'm going to go with publishing also.
Indeed, it was publishing, yes. Renee, you are now at three. Daniel, another spin for you gives you seven, and Brenda picks up three there, brings her up to five. Fourth question. In the world of electronics, what does the D in HDTV stand for? Daniel.
Definition.
Is it definition, digital, or direct? Renee?
Definition.
Brenda?
Definition.
Yes, high definition television. Very nice. Renee, another spin for you. You're now at four. Daniel, three more for you. Put you at 10 now. And Brenda, you pick up one. You're now at six. A lot of spins in this round. This is your last chance to pick up a few more. Your final question. In cooking, what member of the mint family is the primary ingredient used to make pesto? Daniel.
Tarragon.
Is it tarragon, basil, or parsley? Renee?
Basil.
Basil.
It is basil. Yes, basil. All right, at the end of the question round, so many spins to count up. Renee, you get another one there. You'll wrap up this round with five spins. Daniel, you've got 10 to take into the final round. Another spin for you. Brenda gives you seven. And when we come back, we're going straight to the big board to see if they can turn those spins into big bucks. Don't you go anywhere.
I usually draw the big heads and the little bodies, but one of them already had a big head and a little body.
May I ask you a question?
Yeah, who won the 1998 Daytona 500? I said Bobby Labonte.
Wrong, came in second. And they threw that pizza dough in your face?
Yeah, but they sat for a portrait.
That's the whammy, all right.
It's back, Whammy, the all-new Press Your Luck weeknights at 10 p.m. only on Game Show Network.
Turn to the left.
Runners up will receive the Argus Internet Ready digital camera with colored LCD cyber display and audio and video recording capability. Sleek styling with an innovative design for today's lifestyle. An American tradition since 1936 from Argus.
Welcome back, everybody. Here it is. is the big final round of Whammy, the all-new Press Your Luck. And believe me when I tell you, these three players are ready to get down to business. Over $100,000 in cash and prizes on the board up there. Like always, some whammies. Be careful. Hit a whammy. They're going to grab all your cash, leave you flat broke. Hit four of them. You will be out of the game. Renee, you've got one. Brenda, you've got one. So, ladies, please do be careful. As if that weren't enough for you, the big board now throws some double whammies at you. They not only take all your money, they're going to come out here and... Well, dare I say, flirt with you a little bit, get a tad bit obnoxious, all right? Keep in mind that this round, you can pass your remaining spins to the player that's in the lead in hopes that they do hit a whammy. The player, the leader, must take all the spins that have been passed to him. And only the player that's in the lead at the end of the game gets to take home all their cash and all their prizes, all right? Let's have some fun here in the final round. Daniel, of course, you have the advantage here. You will go last in this round because you're currently our leader. Brenda and Renee are both tied at zero, so we go to the player with the least amount of spins. Renee, that's you. $0, one whammy, five spins. Are you ready?
I'm ready.
You want to press your luck?
I'm pressing.
Let's go.
Okay, come on. 5,000. 5,000 in diamonds. Stop.
Stop at table lamps from Tiffany, worth $520. Four spins to go, Renee. Press your luck or pass?
I'm pressing my luck. Okay, okay. Come on, big bucks. Big bucks.
Stop at a Vermont ski week. That's going to be nice. Valued at $3,350. Renee, now you're in first place. $3,870. Three spins to go. What would you like to do?
You know what? I'm going to press it again. I'm going to press it one more time. Okay. One more time. Diamond earrings, 14.
Stop. Oh, double whammy.
Mommy's home, and I've got some lovely fruit and vegetables.
Got your grapes caught in the whammy there, I see, Renee. All right, down to zero, your second whammy of the game. You still have two spins, big bucks up there, great prizes, as you know, can put you right back into the game here. Would you like to press your luck?
Press my luck.
All right.
Press my luck. Come on, home theater system, big bucks, touch!
Stop, and a home theater system worth $599.
Great.
Renee, currently okay. Second place, $1,591 behind Daniel, one spin to go. Would you like to press your luck or pass
press
it?
Press my luck.
Okay.
Press my luck, big bucks!
Renee puts you at $1,799, still in second place. And we go to Brenda with $0, one whammy, seven spins for you. Brenda, you want to press your luck with the first one here?
Press
my luck.
Let's
go.
Okay, no whammy, no whammy, no whammy.
Stop at dinnerware worth $843. Third place, six spins. Press your luck or pass?
Press my luck. No whammy, no whammy, no whammy. Big bucks, big bucks, stop.
Stop at $1,000 or spin again. Which would you like? You want to spin again or you want to take the money?
I want to take the money.
You've got the money. $1,843. There you are in second place. Five spins. What would you like to do?
Press my luck.
All right.
No whammy, no whammy, no whammy. Big bucks, big bucks.
Stop at a mountain bike. Brenda, that's worth $649, and it brings you into first place with $2,492. Four spins to go. Pass or press your luck?
Press my luck. No whammy, no whammy, no whammy, no whammy. Stop.
Stop at $750 and a spin. Brenda, first place with $3,242, still four spins. What would you like to do now? Press your luck or pass them to Daniel?
Pass.
Pass? All right, those four spins now come to you, Daniel. You're looking at a lot of spins. Four spins you have to take, then 10 in your earned column. You're currently in second place. Let's go with your first pass spin now. Good luck.
All right. I think I saw a trick for Antigua out there. Let's go and stop.
Stop at recliners. A matching set worth $568. Still second place. Three more spins you have to take. Here comes your next one.
All right. Big bucks up there. No whammy, no whammy. And stop.
Stop at $500 in a spin.
Take it.
$3,258. Now you're in first place. Here comes your next pass spin, Daniel.
All right. $5,000. I'm ready for you. Big bucks, and stop.
Stop at a ruby and diamond pendant worth $1,160. One more spin. Here it comes, Daniel.
All right, here we go. No whammy. Come on, whammy. Stay away from me. Here we go. Big bucks, and stop.
Stop at a double whammy.
Oh, my.
Daniel, you went from first, dare I say, down to worst. Knocked you out down to zero. The good news is when we come back from this commercial break, you, my friend, have 11 spins to work with, and that's not too bad. Don't miss out on that, folks. It's coming up right after this.
Put yourself in the middle of an hour of marital madness. It's the Newlywed Game and the new Newlywed Game, followed by Hollywood Squares.
Brenda in first place, Renee in second place. Daniel was in first place, but the double whammy knocked him down to zero. You have 11 spins to work with here, Daniel. Would you like to take one now?
Oh, I'm taking it. Let's all go. The way, baby. Here we go. All right, big bucks up there, big bucks, and stop.
Stop at $800.
All right.
Third place, 10 spins to go. Press your luck, okay.
We're going. Here we go. Big bucks, I need a trip time gig up there, and stop.
Stop at $4,000 on a spin. Daniel's in first place now, still 10 spins to go. Pass or press your luck,
That's
Daniel.
A lot of spins to pass. Keep going. Right. Here we go. All right, here we go. Big bucks, and a trip. Stop.
Stop. Ooh, a double whammy. Dunked you right out of first place. Again, Daniel. $0, 9 spins, your second whammy. Press your luck or pass now. Here we go back to the board.
Here we go. Here we go. Big bucks, and stop.
Stop at a kayak with $1,795. In third place, you trail Renee by just $4, 8 spins to go. What would you like to do?
Keep going.
Let's
go. Here we go. All right, no whammies, no whammies. I've had enough of those. Let's go, big bucks, stop.
Stop at a double whammy. Your third whammy, down to zero again. You still have 7 spins. One more whammy, you're out of the game. Should you choose to pass your spins, they will go to Brenda. What would you like to do?
I'm gonna go.
Okay, here we go.
Here we go. All right, big bucks. Big bucks, no whammies, no whammies, and stop.
Stop at Italian Crystal, worth $600. Still 6 spins to go, Daniel. Hit another whammy, Brenda will be our winner, or if you wanna pass, okay, we're pressing your luck.
Here we go. Big bucks! I need big bucks up there! No whammies! Big bucks, and stop!
Stop at $500, $1,100, right. 5 spins to go, Daniel. What would you like to do?
I am gonna keep going. Here we go. All right, big bucks, no whammies, big bucks, and stop!
Stop at a ceiling fan worth $560. $1,660, still in third place, 4 spins, 3
I'm
whammies,
going
here we go.
All the way. Here we go. Big bucks, no whammies, big bucks, no whammies, and stop!
Stop at $500 in a spin. Now you're in second place, Daniel. Daniel, you have 4 spins, you have 3 whammies. If you hit a whammy, the game is over. Brenda will be our winner. Now, if you pass those spins, they will go to Brenda, and she will have to take all 4 of them. What would you like to do?
I'm gonna go one more.
Okay.
One more, here we go. I want big bucks up here. Big bucks, no whammies, big bucks, and stop!
Stop at $800. $2,960, Daniel, second place. If you pass those spins again, they go to Brenda. Should she hit a whammy, you'll be back in first place. What would you like to do?
One more,
he says.
Here we go. Big bucks, no whammies, $5,000. Big bucks, no whammies, and stop!
Stop at $1,100. Daniel, first place now. You climb back up to the top, but you have 2 spins. If you press your luck, you're risking your 4th and final whammy and knock yourself right out of the game. If you pass, they go to Brenda. She'll have to take both of those spins. What would you like to do?
I can't press my luck. I can't afford 4 whammies. I have to pass it.
All right, Brenda, here they come to you. Currently in second place now. 2 spins you have to take. Here comes the first one. Good luck.
4,000, 5,000, 5,000, 5,000. No whammy, no whammy, no whammy. Stop.
Oh, no. Double
whammy. Oh, no.
Brenda, not only are you now covered in whammy fur, but you have $0. The 1 spin from your pass column now goes up to the earn column. You can do with it whatever you'd like. Do you want to press your luck, or do you want to pass it back to Daniel? If you press your luck, you'll need something that gives you another spin to keep things alive unless you hit big bucks. What you gonna do?
I am going to press my luck.
All right, Brenda, you need something that gives you at least $4,060 or something that gives you another spin to keep it alive for you here. If you don't hit that, then Daniel, you will be our winner. All right, here she goes, hoping for big bucks.
$5,000, no whammy, no whammy, $5,000.
$750, it's not enough. And Daniel, how about that? The man that hit three double whammies finds himself in first place with $4,060. Here's Carrie to tell you what you've won.
Daniel, you've won a ceiling fan and crystal stemware. Oneida presents Da Vinci crystal stemware in the Pisa pattern. Exquisite crystal from Italy featuring intricate cuts and a beautiful design from Oneida. Put that together with your $2,900 in cash and your grand total is $4,060.
Thank you so much for being here. Hope you didn't get too messy. I'm sorry about that. Thank you so much for being here, Renee. Hope you had a good time. And you, sir, how about it, Daniel?
All right.
A lot of money, three double whammies, but the man still walks out with his head held up high. Too much rise up here. We'll see you next time on Whammy, the all-new Press Your Luck. Bye-bye, everybody.
Who were you expecting? Santa Claus?
Thank heavens, Classic Hollywood Squares has arrived. Weeknights at 8:30 Eastern.
From the Chuck Barris stages in Hollywood, California.
Survivors may only...